Wickard for the most up-to-date information on mortgage trends, along with timely news on the real estate market. The housing market is in flux, but the national headlines don't often fit local market conditions. Find out what's really happening on the front lines of real estate and mortgage financing in Wisconsin and make better decisions by tuning in every Sunday at 10 a.m. The Acunet Mortgage and Realty Show with Brian and David Wickard on WTMJ.
Hey there, Eric Bilstead for Tri-County Contracting. It's your go-to company. You know the ones for the worry-free roof tune-up. They extend the life of your roof. But not only that, Tri-County Contracting does offer an exclusive 1110 program. What it means is after roofing your house, Chuck and the crew will offer 11 inspections over 10 years for free. Routine maintenance for a decade for free. Learn more about the 1110 program on their website, tricountycontractingwi.com.
Here's to sweet summer days together with friends and family in Wisconsin. To discovering magic in every moment.
Come on, over here.
And to reconnecting through a world filled with wonder.
Wow.
Here's to supper club celebrations and dancing until the sun goes down. Here's to those who Wisconsin. Plan your summer getaway at TravelWisconsin.com.
Trusted, relevant, locally owned, locally programmed. We are Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
It's 6 o'clock. I'm Vince Vetrano. This is Wisconsin's Morning News. Wednesday, March 27th, our top story. A six-year-old shot in Milwaukee.
I'm Adam Roberts, a recovery effort in Baltimore.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Everything's looking pretty good out on the roads. Not seeing too many delays around the area and no incidents to speak of either, so we're in good shape. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Drying out today, decreasing clouds, cooler and breezy, high of just 41, mostly clear and chilly tonight once again with a low down to 25. Milwaukee right now at 28 degrees. And from the WTMJ Breaking News Center, a child shot late Tuesday night. Milwaukee police investigating the shooting, 38th and Villard. Six-year-old was taken to the hospital, is expected to survive. What led up to the shooting still unclear and under investigation. Police are still looking for unknown suspects.
A federal lawsuit accusing a Milwaukee Public Schools principal of abusing a first grader for having gay parents. Former assistant principal at the Milwaukee French Immersion School, Kasongo Kalambula, allegedly told the student his parents would, quote, burn in hell, at one point threatening to kill the student, allegedly, if he told anyone about the abuse. The student is referred to as GL in the lawsuit and is now in psychiatric treatment for trauma and anxiety. Despite allegations, Kalambula was promoted to acting principal of French Immersion, later leaving to become principal of Mary McLeod Bethune Academy, an MPS school he still works at to this day.
If Waukesha County abandons its status as one of four Wisconsin counties without a half-cent sales tax, it could generate $40 to $50 million in revenue. Not everything would go straight to the county budget. Waukesha County Executive Paul Farrell telling Wisconsin's Afternoon News, state statute requires reducing property taxes.
Ours is $1.39 right now per thousand. If we implement a sales tax, a portion of that money would have to go to property tax relief. Then we can look at the other areas and what we would do. That's why I want to put the task force together to really kind of shell out everything of what can happen and how we should go about it.
The county exec creating a task force of 40 municipal, business, and nonprofit leaders to study options like the sales tax for more revenue.
The government of Guatemala saying two of the six presumed dead construction workers who were on the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore when it collapsed Tuesday were Guatemalan. Meanwhile, the U.S. Coast Guard calling off the search for survivors.
Eight construction workers repairing potholes were still on the bridge. Two were later pulled from the water. The six others are now presumed dead. Jesus Campos recently worked on the bridge. He describes the workers as family men, married with children. The Port of Baltimore is now closed, possibly for months. 30,000 cars cross the bridge every day. Perry Russum, ABC News, Baltimore.
President Biden pledging full federal support in funding to repair the bridge if Congress approves it.
Tuesday, the U.S. Supreme Court heard oral arguments in a case centered around access to mifepristone. It's usually part of a two-pill regimen for medication abortions. CBS News Chief Legal Correspondent Jan Crawford at the Supreme Court.
A group of anti-abortion doctors argue the FDA wrongly expanded access to the pill in 2016 when it extended the window women can take it from 7 to 10 weeks. And during the pandemic in 2021, said an in-person doctor's visit was not needed.
Women are now left to receive these drugs in the mail or at in their dorm room without ever having been checked by a doctor for life-threatening conditions. That's reckless.
Abortion rights opponents say the bill has led to emergency complications, while abortion rights supporters say it's an unfounded attempt to further strip away healthcare options.
Someone feels like $1 billion this morning.
Tonight's Mega Millions jackpot is an estimated annuitized $1.13 billion.
There was just one winner in last night's massive jackpot. The ticket was sold in New Jersey, and a lump sum payment nets the winner $537.5 million. If they stretch out payments over 29 years, they can collect the full $1.1 billion. There's another chance to cash in tonight.
Make me a millionaire, Lord. Make me a millionaire.
The Powerball, now at $865 million. Deborah Rodriguez, CBS News.
Coming up, the road to becoming the big cheese starts with a taste test.
Signing Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 6:05.
There are surgeons lining up to be the one to do your joint replacement. But my advice? Exhaust all your options and put off joint replacement as long as you can. Make it your very last resort, because life after joint replacement isn't always what it's cracked up to be. As high as 30% of patients who have undergone joint replacement surgery report unsatisfactory results. And the cost, even with insurance, can be extraordinary. At Rejuvenix, we'll help ease your pain and improve your mobility with FDA-approved pharmacological treatments that precisely target where your pain lives. And by easing your pain and inflammation, we'll help you live a better life. And because we're in-network with most major insurance plans, your out-of-pocket expense could be very affordable. Or nothing at all. This is Richard Salinas, registered nurse with Rejuvenix Arthritis Clinics, where we can alleviate your pain and rejuvenate your life.
Rejuvenix.
Go to Rejuvenix.com to request your appointment.
Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, where reputation matters and character counts. Veteran-owned and operated, go to SemperFiRoofing.com.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 6:06.
Bucks blow a big fourth-quarter lead and then stumble into overtime. We've got that coming up in sports at 6:15.
It's been nearly 12 years since six people were murdered at the Wisconsin Sikh Temple shooting in Oak Creek. Pradeep Kalika's father, one of those six. Pradeep has since been active in the Sikh community and beyond, working on ways to heal, like helping create the documentary Waking in Oak Creek. Kalika tells Wisconsin's Midday News his latest mission is around communal mental health.
Non-practitioners, not people within the mental health field, so that society can understand that they can help their loved ones. So if you're at a corporation, you can help your employees. Or if you're in a school setting, educational setting, that you can help your students, their parents.
Kalika is making that happen as the Behavior Health Responder Director at Carroll University, program for people like first responders and caretakers.
There is a heavy competition to have the best tasting and stretching cheese around.
UW-Madison's Center for Dairy Research may have unlocked the one thing near and dear to people's hearts.
Prolonging the squeakiness of cheese curds.
Crucial in the work are very skilled cheese testers. Panelists must be able to triangulate the acidity, saltiness, and bitterness in a single slice, then identify 16 different aromas. Sensory coordinator Brandon Prochaska shared their latest findings.
We found some potential ways to make that squeak last a lot longer and hopefully avoid any sort of mushy curds.
Julia Fallow, WTMJ News.
Discovering with the cheese, it's kind of like the weather. I don't care why it's going to rain today. I just care if it's going to rain. So I don't need to see all the fronts and the things and this moving through for 3.5 minutes. Just, is it raining today or no? And with the cheese, is it tasty or no?
So you're not a,
I don't care how you guys get there.
Mr. Squeaky over here. Are you not a squeak guy?
Oh, I like it, but just I don't care why. 6:08 on Wisconsin's Morning News.
Hey, boaters!
Truly the best supplier around for all of our boating needs. This place is magic. I call it my candy store for boating parts. This is Dave Doro from Kendor Marine. And yeah, I said it, but these are the actual words of our satisfied and loyal customers. Boaters in the know exactly where to go, and there's a reason. We've got it all for our boater buddies. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water. Hey, boaters!
Now, I wasn't eavesdropping. I just happened to overhear him talking about us. He said if you know what you're looking for, just rummage around. You'll find it. And it's true, because we stock more boat parts and accessories than anyone. Even those oddball parts you thought you'd never find. This is Dave Doro, and boaters in the know exactly where to go. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water.
For over a century, local radio has evolved with the needs of the community. From politics to pop culture, we keep you informed, bringing you the most relevant news online, on air, and on the go. You have trusted us with your news, sports, weather, and entertainment. Trust us to keep moving with you. Text radio to 52886 and tell Congress local broadcasting is here to stay.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here. Transform your bathroom like we did. It's Sidex, S-I-D-E-X, Sidex. Take out that conventional bathtub, put in a walk-in shower. That's what we did at our house. It's beautiful. It's open. It's transformed our bathroom. And right now with Sidex, you get $750 off any bathtub or shower replacement. They serve within 60 miles of Milwaukee. It's Sidex. They did the work at our house. It was quick. It was affordable, it was efficient, and our bathroom is beautiful. Go with the company we trust, Sidex. Free shower door upgrade when you mention WTMJ or John Mercure.
Download the free Upside app to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code GIFT for an extra 25 cents per gallon on your first fill-up. That's promo code GIFT.
610, let's get our first update here on the roads, Deb.
All right, it's looking pretty good right now. Vince, really not seeing any delays out there, and volume super light as well. No incidents to speak of. So far, so good. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. Decreasing cloud cover this morning will give us lots of afternoon sunshine. Breezy winds out of the west will keep high temperatures down in the upper 30s to low 40s. Tonight, mostly clear and chilly. Low temperatures drop into the mid-20s. Plenty of sunshine throughout the entire day on Thursday with high temperatures in the mid-40s. Most of Friday will be dry with increasing clouds. Then Friday night to Saturday morning, we'll see the chance for a few rain showers. High temperatures will be in the 40s to low 50s. Sunday, still a small chance for an isolated rain shower. Mostly cloudy skies and high temperatures in the mid-40s. I'm meteorologist Tyler Moore with the Storm Team Forecast on WTMJ.
Milwaukee at 28 degrees.
Live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee, this is Wisconsin's Morning News. Here's your host, Vince Vetrano.
Wednesday morning, 11 minutes after 6. Glad you're along with us. Eric Bilstead still out for the week. Adam Roberts in for him this morning. I found the could it happen here style reporting that we are often guilty of to some degree in the local news to be oftentimes to be a bit silly.
Sure.
Right. Okay. With the epic bridge collapse in Baltimore, search for six people now presumed dead is suspended this morning after that cargo ship slammed into the bridge support structure that toppled the whole thing. I think more than a few folks did have a thought driving over the Hone Bridge this week, you know. Could something like that happen to our huge bridge right there in the port? Local port officials and first responders had that on their minds as well.
If we had something like that here, it would be kind of an all hands type of an event. Part of their morning conversation was just talking about the bridge and the response and some of the things they would do. Get you kind of thinking about some new things.
Skylar Belot, their assistant chief of operations for Milwaukee Fire, talking with TMJ4's Mary Jo Ola. Came up at the morning meeting.
Yes, I believe we were talking about it.
So are we prepared for that type of critical response? Do we need to ask questions? Should we be learning from crews in Baltimore? And that's all good. We want those guys to be asking those questions. And as far as the Hone or other structures in our port, not really the same deal.
Right.
First of all, the main support structures for the Hone, specifically if you look at it, they're on land. So while this was a cargo ship that slammed directly into a support structure for this huge bridge in Baltimore, you wouldn't have that as ships are entering the straight cut, as they call it, into our harbor.
It would take a pretty big leap over the concrete to have any right. sort of big impact.
Not the only difference. Port of Milwaukee released a statement, as I'm sure they were talking about this incident as we were. I'll let Mary Jo tell it here.
In a statement, Port Milwaukee officials say the area does not receive ships as large as the one involved in the Baltimore incident. They say the ones that use Port Milwaukee are similar in length, but half as wide.
So could it happen here exactly like it played out in Baltimore? Unlikely, but good to know that the people who need the answer to that question are on top of it.
I would agree. And that came across my mind, too. I know my sister in particular hates bridges. And so she reached out to me like, oh, my God, I don't want to go back to Milwaukee and go over the Honey. I had to be like, calm down.
Okay, right.
It's okay. But it's good to at least have these things in your mind. And I think when a lot of these things happen, the good response, if you're not in that immediate area, is to kind of reevaluate, okay, what maybe are we doing right or wrong that we could improve in our own area?
A lot of big ships in and out of our harbor. We will get a live update from ABC News at 8:40 this morning about the situation in Baltimore specifically. We'll join by ABC News correspondent Derek Dennis. He's been following the latest on that investigation. Sports is coming up next.
The very front of the front office is exclusively on Wisconsin's Morning News.
We're focused on winning today, and that's where our head is.
Brewers Senior Vice President and General Manager Matt Arnold is our Brewers 360 guest.
Have you ever played Immaculate Grid? Let's try it. I've never played this game with a general manager, so I figure we can do this in 9 guesses.
Every Thursday at 7:45.
Oh, I don't know, buddy. I'm not sure. I need a little more coffee for this.
Presented by Holiday Automotive and Outdoor Living Unlimited.
That'll be fun. All right. Can't wait.
Vince Vetrano for Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin with another amazing deal to pass on to you. If you've been waiting to replace your drafty old windows and doors, or you just want to revitalize your home with a new look, want to modernize it, want to change the colors, want to change the look entirely, now's the time to get it done. Here's the deal going through March 31st. 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. You Pella now, you pay later. Pella has this free in-home consultation where they bring the crews in, and they do a lot more than just measure out the space and then give you the menu of options. Well, here's this kind of window. Here's the double pane, the triple pane. Here's the kind of glass that's in there, inside there. They help you design your home because they have unique looks, different styles. And with DesignWorks, the in-home Pella team can show you what your project is going to look like before you commit to buying, so you know exactly what you're getting. If you need big sizes, custom colors or finishes, they've got it all. And here's the deal through March 31st, 0% interest for up to 3 years on your financing. Get the Pella team in your home by setting a free consultation at PellaWI.com. Certain restrictions do apply.
Now, time for a sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All sports desk. Here's Greg Hill.
Yeah, it was the Bucks hosting the LeBron-less Lakers last night. And what was a 19-point lead turned into a tie game into the fourth quarter. The score 101-101. Lakers running an out-of-bounds play and...
they get it into Reeves. He fires up the three. Oh, he almost banked it in. It rimmed out, and we go to overtime.
Overtime it
why?
Is.
Why do we go to overtime?
Oh, we go to overtime.
Were we up big?
We're up 19 at one point, and then just kept missing shots. Anthony Davis for the Lakers, who's usually... has a reputation of being a little slower on the court, kind of dogging it at times, decided to play his heart out. Okay. They were gassed by, and I'll tell you why, because there's still more to go. Because we're in overtime. Scores 117-117. One final play. This time the Bucks have the ball.
Inbound pass goes to Dame. Dame takes it inside. Scoops the shot up. It's blocked by Davis. Anthony Davis protects the scoreboard, and we're going to double overtime.
Yeah, double overtime it is. Who ordered it? Let's go. Trading buckets back and forth. What would be an awesome game, but would spell the end.
Now they get it to Reeves. Open three, and he drills it. Lakers by three with 37.8 seconds to go.
Man, they say LeBron didn't play, but it looked like LeBron James was wearing an Austin Reeves jersey. Dude had just absolutely balled out a couple free throws later, and...
bing, that's the end of that. You know, it's the only thing he can say.
Yeah, Bucks fall to the Lakers. Double OT, 128-124. Super fun game, not a super fun result. Next up for the Bucks, they head to New Orleans to take on the Pelicans on Thursday. Speaking of Thursday, that is when the Brewers open the regular season. For what it's worth, the Brewers fall in their last spring training game to the Rockies. Doesn't matter. None of it matters. It's spring training. We can put all the past, all of our upset notions about the spring training, put it in the past. All the times we were pumped up, like yesterday, because of all the hit home runs, put in the past. Does not matter. The 162 season game season starts on Thursday in New York against the Mets. Not to be that guy, but I'm about to be the forecast Citi Field tomorrow morning or around noon. Well, it looks like rain.
Oh, say it ain't so, Alanis.
We waited so long. Nothing official yet, just something to keep an eye on. Remember, what Major League Baseball does, they install that off day, use the next day after a team's official season opener, so the Brewers have off on Friday. The season opener's postponed. They may play Friday because they may not play Thursday. No, not calling it yet. It's just something to keep your eye on.
stuff. Why can't we plug into the algorithm to play in domed stadiums to start the season?
You would think, right?
Right? I mean, like, we could play that game here.
Yeah, but if you make that argument, then you can make that game for game 45. Well, why isn't there a dome? You just play this game. You know what I mean? Like, just because it's the
opener. Just put domes on them all.
Yeah, there you go.
Fair enough. Hey, coming up next, a young lady who's originally from Greendale is about to run across the state of Wisconsin, and she plans to do it in just 6 days. Her story coming up.
All of the drama, all of the heart-pounding anticipation, all of the dancing.
Rises up, it's good, and it's good, it's good!
Keep it here on WTMJ for all of your March hoops craziness during every sports update on Wisconsin's morning and afternoon news. Sponsored by Outdoor Living Unlimited. Don't miss a single moment of this.
At the buzzer, got it! Are you kidding me?
All tourney long on WTMJ.
Make this summer the best one yet. Let Fox World Travel plan your next family vacation. Whether it's a magical Disney escape, an all-inclusive resort in paradise, or a thrilling European adventure, we offer exclusive savings for your family. Enjoy exciting activities, educational experiences, or peaceful retreats where you can relax and recharge with our trusted partners like Globus Family of Brands, Disney, and Insight Vacations. Visit foxworldtravel.com or call 866-GO-FOX-GO to start planning your summer vacation today.
6:20 on Wisconsin's Morning News. Debbie, what do you have?
Well, we've got a pretty good ride shaping up so far this morning. Not seeing too many delays out there or incidents for that matter. Even the construction zones are so far so good, pretty clear. Volume's light, so we're good. And while you're out navigating the roads as quickly and safely as possible, if you do happen to see something we should know about, give us a call on the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen Traffic Tip Line. It's 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
We get to the Storm Team forecast through the weekend. High 41 degrees today and drying out under decreasing clouds. Bit on the cooler side, as we indicated here, and breezy conditions continue. Mostly clear, chilly once again with a low tonight down to 25. Thursday, high of 45. We will see the sun. Mostly sunny skies on Thursday. Friday, increasing clouds with chance of rain moving in late. And a split high, 46 at the lake, 53 if you're further away from Lake Michigan. For the weekend, chance of showers lingering into Saturday morning. High of 50 at the lake, 55 inland. And Sunday's high just 44 degrees with a slight chance of a shower. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Right now, Milwaukee temp at 29. On this Wednesday morning, March is Multiple Sclerosis Awareness Month. And maybe if it hadn't been, I admit, I would not have spent time making myself aware of what it is. It's not something that's touched my family or anyone that I know. So this is one of the reasons they have these months, right?
That
makes
sense.
The day, the month, the whatever. So always been one of those conditions, didn't know much about nor understand. But it's a local story here that caught my attention. A woman originally from Greendale, where our family lives now, connected with me. Her name is Brittany Heights Walters. She is going to run across the state of Wisconsin, so the width of the state, this summer, and she's going to do it in 6 days. It's an effort to raise money for MS research, prevention, treatment, one day a cure, and she's got multiple reasons for taking part.
It's a cross-country relay run. It covers 3,260 miles total. It starts in Santa Monica, California, and it ends in New York.
If I'm correct here, you're going to run essentially a marathon a day for a number of days straight?
Yes, exactly. So,
well, how are you going to do that?
I don't know. We'll see. we'll see how it goes. But I haven't done anything like this before, so I'm really excited. But I've been training now. Total training will be about 10 months.
She's committed to raising at least $10,000 in the effort to better understand MS.
Multiple sclerosis, or MS, a potentially debilitating movement disorder, and affects over 2.2 million people worldwide. And it's an autoimmune disease, which is characterized by damage to neurons in the central nervous system.
And those neurons are pretty important.
Since neurons are necessary for most human functions, like how we think, feel, move, MS can lead to a range of symptoms. They're often unpredictable, things like movement slowing, weakness, pain, balance impairments, cognitive changes, depression.
A lot of information, and Brittany should know she's a PhD in kinesiology, an assistant professor of neuromechanics and motor control at Seattle University. This is what she does. And what are the chances her roommate from college was recently diagnosed with MS?
So my dear friend Lisa, she was diagnosed with MS a few years ago, and just her resilience and determination as she faced the challenges of her diagnosis, and then she also ran this same segment that I'll be running after her diagnosis. So she's really served as an inspiration for me to become involved with this organization and apply to do the run.
An inspiration to run from Platteville to Milwaukee, where fittingly the finish line party will be at a brewery.
Starting at 11 a.m. at City Lights Brewery in Milwaukee, so funds raised there will also go to the organization's mission.
Man, how glad are you going to be to have a beer?
Very glad. I'm glad that it ends at a brewery. I'm all for it.
Every stride, one step closer to a cure for MS. Vince Vetrano, WTMJ News. So Brittany's leg of the run comes up in early July. The MS Run the U.S. Relay. So she's doing one leg, but again, it goes across the entire country. It's generated some $3 million over the years that they've been doing this. You have to be chosen to run. So a tribute to Brittany for being selected and super committed to the cause. I say this oftentimes when I talk to people like her. Thank God for smart people. Right, did you hear her title, like kinesiology and study of this kind of mechanic? Okay, she's on the front edge of trying to understand a little bit more about this disease. I did ask her, Adam, I'm like, project out 10 years or however long into the future that you want to look like. Are we at cure? Are we better at preventing? And mostly like where they are, according to her, is just they're trying to understand. They don't even necessarily know all the root causes of multiple sclerosis. Right. And until you do that, it's hard to get at what can we do to improve lives.
Right. It feels in my world similar to Alzheimer's. I know it's impacting my family, and I had Marty Schreiber in here a while ago and had that one-on-one with him, and it felt the same way, where it's a disease where we just are still, even all these years after it was initially discovered, just trying to understand it more. But that is a very important step when you get towards that ultimate goal of finding a cure.
A lot of people, a lot of smart people working on it. If you want to learn more about her efforts, the relay, or you want to help, she's a little more than halfway to her fundraising goal of $10,000. You can text the word RUN, R-U-N, to 855-616-1620. And I'll send you a link to the story on our website, which includes a link to Brittany's fundraising page. 626 on Wisconsin's Morning News. News about your money this morning. WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Dow Jones Industrial Average fell about 31 points to 39,282. NASDAQ down nearly 70 to 16,316. And the S&P 500 closed Tuesday at 5204. That was down about 14.5 points. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review. From a fee-only fiduciary, go to annexwealth.com. Click on the Get Started button now.
Your nose is for breathing, your mouth is for eating. And if you're breathing through your mouth, it's not because your body wants to, it's because it has to, because your nose isn't working properly. And although you've lived like this, it's no way to live, and it's having a significant impact on your life. I know you know this, and I know that taking action isn't always convenient, but at Advent, we've done all we can to make changing your life for the better as easy as possible. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula. With tens of thousands of our patients, a thorough breathing triangle evaluation, along with a simple 20-minute in-office procedure called balloon sinuplasty, has opened their nasal passages, allowing them to breathe freely through their nose for good. And there's a good chance this procedure can do the same for you. We'll help you breathe through your nose again, and it will change your life.
Go to AdventNose.com to schedule your appointment, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Hey, WTMJ's John Merck here. I've got a great trip coming up this Christmas. I want you to be with us. It's Magical Christmas Markets. 5 nights in Innsbruck, the capital of the Alps. We'll take in a horse-drawn carriage ride, make traditional strudel, and spend lots of time shopping in beautiful, historic Christmas markets throughout Europe. It is going to be special hunting for those treasures. I've got a beautiful brochure. I'll send it to you. Shoot me an email, john.mercure@wtmj.com. john.mercure, M-E-R-C-U-R-E, at wtmj.com. Magical Christmas Markets. kids. This December, won't you come with us?
Is it time to give your home a new look?
Absolutely.
Get personal care from Adair. Adair Floors and Remodeling has a design team ready to help with all flooring and remodeling needs, including tub-to-shower conversions. Want to create your dream kitchen, including cabinets? How about the rec room? Adair Floors and Remodeling has been family-run in Franklin for over 65 years. For floors and all home remodeling needs, get personal care from Adair. Adair Floors and Remodeling, South 27th Street in Franklin, and online at adairfloors.com.
Wisconsin's Morning News National Anthem by the Menominee Falls High School Chorus.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the
It's 6:30. I'm Vince Vitrano. This is Wisconsin's Morning News. Our top story, a child shot overnight in Milwaukee.
I'm Adam Roberts. Allegations of abuse against an MPS principal.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Everything's looking great out on the roads. Light volume and full freeway speeds. That's your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Decreasing clouds today with a high of just 41 degrees. Right now in Milwaukee at 29.
ABC News, I'm Sherry Preston, the chairman of the NTSB, Jennifer Homendy, in Maryland at the scene of the Key Bridge collapse in Baltimore. Her main focus and the focus for her investigators, figuring out exactly what went wrong on that cargo ship prior to the collision with the bridge.
We've seen all the reports and heard the reports about power losses and it striking the bridge at the time when a number of workers were on the bridge, but it's still something we need to confirm.
The six construction workers they were looking for yesterday are believed to have died in the collision and collapse. Crews will be searching the water today again for their bodies. Sean Combs' lawyers speaking out about the raids on the media moguls' homes. They say they were unfair. The same storm system that brought flooding and hail to Georgia and Florida, as well as heavy snow to the upper Midwest earlier this week, moving east. Ping-pong-sized hail reported in Florida yesterday. Just one winning ticket sold in last night's billion-dollar-plus Mega Millions drawing, sold in New Jersey. This is ABC News.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 6:31.
From the WTMJ Breaking News Center this morning, a child shot late Tuesday night in Milwaukee. Police investigating. The child is expected to survive. 38th and Villard is where this played out. The six-year-old taken to the hospital. What led up to that shooting? Still under investigation. Police say they are seeking unknown suspects.
A federal lawsuit accuses a Milwaukee Public Schools principal of abusing a first grader for having gay parents. Former assistant principal at Milwaukee French Immersion School, Kasongo Kalambula, allegedly told the student his parents would burn in hell and at one point allegedly threatened to kill the student if he told anyone about the abuse. The student is referred to in the lawsuit as GL and now is in psychiatric treatment for trauma and anxiety. The complaint also states Kalambula would allegedly lock GL in a dark room for hours and failed to protect GL from other students who bullied him. Despite the allegations, Kalambula was promoted to acting principal of French Immersion, later left to become principal at Mary McLeod Bethune Academy, where he still works at to this day.
Waukesha County considering a half-cent sales tax to keep funding big-ticket budget items like the Sheriff's Department. County Executive Paul Farrell telling Wisconsin's Afternoon News the consideration is not because of the Milwaukee County sales tax increase.
We're in a different position. Waukesha County, third largest county, we have the lowest spending of any county in the state per person. So I think we're very fiscally prudent, but we still have high level of services. We've been able to balance that out. The challenges come in. We're capped by how much property levy we can have.
And Farrell also said Ozaukee County, the only other county in the state with a lower tax rate than Waukesha.
It shouldn't take a tragedy to bring community together like this and keep community together like this, but that's what happened.
Tragedy struck Oak Creek in 2012 when a gunman opened fire on the Wisconsin Sikh temple, killing six people. Pardeep Kalika tells Wisconsin's Midday News his father was one of those six, and he's since been on a mission to help his community heal from the effects. But he wishes Wisconsin would take more initiative to prevent hate crime.
Creating infrastructure around hate crime prevention, or sometimes what we call targeted violence prevention, we're a little bit behind. Illinois is obviously working on creating infrastructure. I was just in Providence, Rhode Island. They are creating infrastructure to address hate.
You can hear the entire conversation on WTMJ.com or wherever you get your podcasts.
Do you know your Splenda from your Stevia? Non-nutritive sweeteners have become just as commonplace as artificial substitutes for cane sugar, but new studies show that even these plant-derived sugar substitutes have health implications. President and CEO of the Medical College of Wisconsin, Dr. John Raymond, with Wisconsin's Afternoon News.
Beverages that contain non-nutritive sweeteners increase the risk of atrial fibrillation by 20%. Sweeteners with natural sweeteners increase the risk by 10%. And to put it into perspective, that 20% risk with non-nutritive sweeteners was with just one can of soda per day.
Dr. Raymond adds non-nutritive sweeteners often increase sugar cravings, thus leading to weight gain, which you were trying to avoid in the first place.
Of course.
Traffic is sponsored by Sendix Food Market, your trusted local grocer since 1926.
Don't miss Sendix Seafood Spectacular this Thursday through Saturday. Great deals like premium wild-caught halibut fillets, just $9.99 per pound. Sendix, your trusted local grocer.
Coming up, a workforce that's overstaffed?
News is sponsored by Annex Wealth Management's Money Talk. That's heard Saturdays at 10 right here on WTMJ.
Like it or not, you are a media-consuming machine, chased all day by headlines, texts, emails, on the TV, the computer, the phone, even your smartwatch. News about market volatility and uncertainty could lead to anxiety and planning paralysis. No surprise, Americans report increased stress about their investment and retirement plans. This isn't a time to be frozen in place. Take action. Put Annex Wealth Management on your side. Build a plan that will help cut through the noise. We'll provide comprehensive investment and retirement guidance that includes tax and estate planning. Let Annex do a deep dive on your portfolio, offer unbiased advice with Wealthmetric, and work to create a solid plan for you and your family. Turn down the media roar. Dial up the planning. Head to AnnexWealth.com and click the Get Started button. It takes only a couple of minutes. Set your own appointment. In person or online, it's time to take action and know the difference with a fee-only fiduciary. That's Annex Wealth Management. AnnexWealth.com.
Remember the ice storm of 76? We cooked frozen pizza with matchsticks. We used homemade aluminum foil solar panels to stay warm. And we were without power for 9 months. Or was it 9 days? I don't know. I was 5 years old, so my memory's a little fuzzy. Probably from all the frostbite. The point is, a prolonged period without power is no picnic. Fortunately, technology has improved significantly since 76. Today, we have backup emergency generators to keep power powering and furnaces furnacing when the weather gets wild. Call Mr. Holland's Home Services to schedule the installation of a brand new, high-efficiency gas furnace and AC or generator combo for a whole lot less than you'd typically pay. Plus, we make it easy to pay with up to 24 months interest-free financing with approved credit. 866-992-1717. Or visit MrHollandsHomeServices.com. If you're haunted by the spirit of 76, we can help.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 637.
Brewers put a wrap on spring training. Look ahead to opening day in sports at 645.
The Army navigating some staffing issues. It has too many soldiers in some positions and not enough in others. So right now, the Army offering bonuses to troops who will switch from the overstaffed jobs to understaffed ones, and is willing to promote them faster as well.
The Army is trying to retain its people, but in the right jobs. It has too many cavalry scouts and military police, and not enough air defense, counter-drone, and electronic warfare experts. It will pay soldiers between $6,000 and $72,000 to switch into about a dozen specialties. The Army says, for now, it won't force soldiers to change jobs when they reenlist, but its regulations do allow it to deny a soldier's request to reenlist in an overstaffed position. Christopher Cruz, CBS News, Washington.
Military.com saying that the Army to do all of this is planning to cut about 24,000 positions from its workforce, moving a lot of their forces from the counterinsurgency departments, counterterrorism, to focus more on those cyber warfare elements of things and drone craft.
You know, we sometimes forget the military is a calling for many. It is a service to our country, but it is also a job for all of those folks who go into that field and to that service. So it has to be managed to some degree for people's interests, for their skill set, all of those things, just like any other company.
I had to wonder how long it was going to get before we got to this point where a lot of those more infantry jobs, those more boots on the ground, got shifted back to more or less your office positions, manning drones from a mobile site as we kind of progress into the next era of warfare.
Signing Unlimited, WTMJ News Time is 6:38.
Home to the Auto Show, Tattoo Fest, RV Show, and more. Milwaukee's top trade and consumer shows belong at Baird Center. They make it easy, from a walkable downtown location to over 20 loading docks and a newly expanded exhibit hall, ensuring your exhibitors and attendees have an unforgettable visit. There's never been a better time to bring your next event downtown. Baird Center, Milwaukee's home for trade shows in the heart of the city. Learn more today at BairdCenter.com/planners. That's BairdCenter.com/planners.
I would love to come out and pave your parking lot. Vince Vetrano here for Johnson & Sons Paving. Great contest we've got going right now with our partners there. It's pothole season, going to be a brutal one with all the back and forth temperatures. Those little cracks, those small little holes are turning into big ones here this spring. You want Johnson & Sons to come out and fix those potholes before they get worse in your commercial parking lot, or maybe it's time to rebuild the whole thing. Here's the contest. If you book a parking lot paving project by the end of May with Johnson & Sons Paving, you are entered to win the Vinny visit. I've told the Johnson & Sons team I am available on your job site. That doesn't sound good to you to have me actually working out there. Well, you're the customer. We'll just sit. I'll bring coffee. We'll chat and we'll watch the Johnson & Sons team do their thing. You can go to WTMJ.com/contests for information on how to enter. Asphalt and concrete. Plenty of Johnsons over there. No subcontractors except for me. JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com.
Heiser Ford has slam dunk lease deals this month. Score big on a 23 Bronco Sport or a 23 Escape with affordable leases starting at under $300 a month. Yes, under $300 a month. Plus, we will be awarding our MVPs with our exclusive Safe and Sound program, which is included on each vehicle sale. See all details at HeiserFord.com. At Heiser, today's your day.
See dealer for complete details. Tax, title, license, and $399 service fees extra. Ends March 31st.
The Midwest's best baseball and softball training facility and retail center is here in New Berlin, and it's ready for you and your team. From little leaguers to hardcore players and trainers, this is the place you'll want to be.
You can't beat Burkhart.
Find furniture for life from Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee.
Get started with your no-hassle refi checkup by clicking on the blue button at Acunet.com.
Traffic is brought to you by Rejuvenix, your non-surgical joint therapy experts.
Rejuvenix, alleviate your pain, rejuvenate your life.
Go to Rejuvenix.com to request your appointment.
Debbie, what do you see on the roads this morning?
Well, we got some backups now on 894 westbound, as you might expect, right through that construction zone right around Loomis, and that stretches all the way to about 68th Street. On and off the brakes as they're working on the median area. We've also got northbound on 43, just a quick tap of the brakes just north of Keefe. Otherwise, everything else is rolling along just fine. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. All the rain is behind us, and now we'll see more sunshine as we work through the day today with decreasing clouds and high temperatures in the upper 30s and lower 40s. Breezy winds out of the west will continue for today. Tonight, mostly clear skies and chilly, low temperatures dropping into the 20s. Plenty of sunshine for Thursday with high temperatures in the mid-40s. Most of Friday will be dry with increasing clouds. Then rain chances return Friday night into Saturday morning. High temperatures as we head towards the week will be in the 40s to low 50s. Sunday, a slight chance for an isolated rain shower. Mostly cloudy with high temperatures in the mid-40s. I'm meteorologist Tyler Moore with the Storm Team Forecast on WTMJ.
Milwaukee at 29 degrees. Ancient Aliens Live Project Earth coming to the Pabst Theater this week. The show is March 29th, so that's Friday, and we're sending you there all this week. More on that in a moment. This is a live adaptation of the show that's really popular on History Channel. You've probably seen it if you didn't stop and watch. At least it was there in front of you, where they talk about ancient alien theorists, ancient astronaut theorists.
It's going to be like a greatest hit of ancient aliens. And so all your favorite historical mysteries, whether it's Stonehenge, the pyramids, we're going to be taking people back in time all around the world, and then bridging the gap with the modern UFO mystery and everything going on now in the government with Congress pushing for answers on this.
And that's Nick Pope. If you're a fan of the show, you recognize his voice. He's a UFO investigator. He's going to be here in Milwaukee this week. Now, he mentioned Congress, and here's my favorite part of the interview that we did with Nick yesterday on Wisconsin's Morning News. I asked him, UFO investigator, and if you listen to our show, you know Eric and I have spent a lot of time on the recent testimony before Congress. Military intelligence personnel claiming that not only does our government have knowledge of intelligent life elsewhere, but that we have interacted with that and, in fact, even used alien tech to reverse engineer our own stuff. So Nick Pope, UFO investigator, true or no?
We don't know. That's the short answer. And that's why
Tell me the answer, Nick.
In Congress, you know, both in the Senate and the House, the intelligence committees, the armed services committees, the oversight committees are really trying to get the government to say, look, what do you know about all this? Let's get all these whistleblowers in to the secure classified areas where they can reveal this. And then we hopefully find out what's true and what isn't.
So really, what he does and what the show does is not necessarily try to lead you to particular conclusions. Pope and the others on the show, they lay out the evidence. What is fact that we actually know? They pose the interesting questions, and that's what they're going to do in this live show. So if you want to go, we've got two tickets for caller number 5 this morning, 855-616-1620. Caller number 5 to the WTMJ talk and text line gets a pair of tickets to Friday's show, Ancient Aliens Live at the Pabst Theater. Keep listening through the week for your chance to win again on Wisconsin's Morning News.
He told us to load 4 yards into his 8-foot bed, but we knew that 3 full, honestly measured yards were going to fill his truck bed to the rim. After we proved that, he told us the other guys had been telling him he's been getting 4 yards in there for years. Honest measurements and honest folks who just want to do you right. So you come back. Erickson's Landscape Supply, high-quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less. Commercial or residential, visit ericsonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection. We did the math. When you buy bagged mulch from the big guys, you pay $50 a yard. Why pay more for inferior mulch? When you buy from Erickson's, you'll get premium mulch for almost half the cost. And you'll see that even our economy mulch is better, for less than half the cost of bag mulch. And either choice is made with premium colorant that lasts longer. Erickson's Landscape Supply, high-quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less. Commercial or residential, visit ericsonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection.
Now, time for a sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. Here's Greg Hill.
Yeah, no LeBron for the Lakers last night as they came into Fizer Forum. The Bucks hosting the Lakers. They held a 19-point lead at one point. But somehow, you blinked, you look up, tie game in the fourth quarter, scores 101 apiece, Lakers running an out-of-bounds play, and...
They get it into Reeves, he fires up the three, oh, he almost banked it in. It rimmed out, and we go to overtime.
Yeah, overtime we go. We fast forward through overtime, 117 to 117, one more play, this time the Bucks have the ball.
Inbound pass goes to Dame. Dame takes it inside, scoops the shot up, it's blocked by Davis. Anthony Davis protects the scoreboard, and we're going to double overtime.
Okay, double overtime it is. And by the way, these dudes gassed, absolutely just panting.
Well, we do not need this that late in the season either,
right?
No, right.
There's 10 games left of the regular season. Don't look now. But it was a tough one. Not fortunate for the Lakers. They have a back-to-back tonight against the Memphis Grizzlies. As for the Bucks, double overtime continues. This is kind of what spelled the end for them.
Now they get it to Reeves. Open three, and he drills it. Lakers by 3 with 37.8 seconds to go.
Yeah, a couple of free throws later, the Lakers beat the Bucks in double OT, 128 to 124. Super fun game, not a fun result. The Bucks head to New Orleans to take on the Pelicans on Thursday. Speaking of Thursday, the Brewers open up the regular season, we think, because the forecast in New York on Thursday around noon. Man, I can't believe it. So, like, there's a whole, like, band going up the East Coast, so it's not just the Mets, but as far as it impacts us, Not calling anything yet, but they are looking at some rain on Thursday around, just around first pitch.
Not one of those where like, well, we see a window here between the notes.
Oh, no, it's a wall. Yeah, they're tracking it. Even the Today had Al had it. They okay. It's so stay tuned. Hopefully we have baseball starting on Thursday. If not, we'll start it on Friday. Some Packers nuggets real quick. They got a kicker, Greg Joseph from the Vikings, signing to the green and gold, according to his agent who posted on X. The team has also reportedly began, quote, preliminary discussions on a contract extension for Jordan Love, left set to become an unrestricted free agent in 2025. And the rumor mill turns on the possibility of the Packers being the opponent to the Eagles on week one in the season opener in Brazil this year. That game on Friday, September 6th. Now, the Packers do have that reputation. Being global, they're everywhere, right? You could be in France and you have a story about someone who lives in Fond du Lac and you met right. them because they had Packers gear. So it happens. Nothing official yet, but something to keep your eye on.
Wisconsin's Morning News road trip for sure.
Hey, let's go.
Coming up next.
Ultimately, 17 of the 20 attempts missed the tires.
We need better training at this.
That story next on Wisconsin's Morning News.
Hey, this is Ben Brust from Kyle Brust and Ortman on ESPN Wisconsin. People can't stop screaming about the Screaming Sicilian Frozen Pizza, and no wonder, there's plenty to scream about, like the buttery stone-fired crust, secret recipe tomato sauce, mounds of whole milk mozzarella, and tons of premium toppings. Find Screaming Sicilian in your local grocer's freezer and find out for yourself why Sport called Screaming Sicilian's Holy Pepperoni Frozen Pizza the best of the best. Screaming Sicilian, taste what all the screaming is about.
I'm going to say it again. Our mission is to protect and uphold our reputation. And what that means is wherever we go, we make it better for those in need of our services and the great people we have working with us. Our reputation matters. Over the years, we've cut our losses with a handful of people that just didn't live our values as much as we'd like. And a lot of them, if not all of them, still work in the industry today. I say this because I want you to know when you work with Semper Fi, character counts. It's why you can count on the industry's hands-down best lifetime workmanship warranty that now includes free annual inspections. And it's why we always have one project manager per job, which is absolutely not the industry standard. When you're paying for a brand new roof to go on what's likely the biggest investment you have, you want it done right, and you want to be able to count on the people doing it. This is Brad Youngwith with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
Listen to The Fix-It Show this Saturday morning in the 7 o'clock hour with special guest Chris Mancuso from Accurate Basement Repair. Chris will discuss and answer questions about basement problems and solutions. Accurate Basement Repair serves all of southeastern Wisconsin with comprehensive, cost-effective basement repairs, including foundation restoration and waterproofing. Check them out online at AccurateBasementRepair.com and listen to The Fix-It Show this Saturday starting at 7 a.m. with Accurate Basement Repair's Chris Mancuso.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
651. Debbie, what do you see on the roads this morning?
Well, we got some backups, 894 westbound, now starting right around 27th Street, stretching all the way to 68th. That is through that construction zone right past Loomis, where they're rebuilding that bridge and they're working on the median. It's a couple of lanes blocked off, kind of long-termish, so just be extra careful. Northbound on 43, we are starting to see delays from before Center Street all the way up to Keith. Rest of the system looking pretty good. I'm Debbie Lozago with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Storm Team forecast from meteorologist Tyler Moore this morning. Decreasing clouds, drying out today, high of 41 degrees. Tonight's low down to 25. Mostly sunny on Thursday with a high of 45. Friday, 46 at the lake, 53 your high temperature inland. Increasing clouds with a chance of rain moving in late. That rain could linger into Saturday with the chance of morning showers. High of 50 at the lake, 55 inland, and Sunday's high just 44 with a slight chance of a shower. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Right now, 29 in Milwaukee. Wisconsin's Morning News, bringing our friend and teammate from 101.7 The Truth and former Milwaukee Police Lieutenant Dr. Ken Harris this morning. Interesting thing to put in front of you this morning, Dr. Ken.
Now, why would you do? See, the topic is just, well, go ahead.
All right, start. Well, we talk a lot about reckless driving in our area, police pursuits. How can we both pursue suspects whom we would like to see taken into custody and also preserve safety on the road at high speeds. And one of the tools so oft deployed, we hear about stop sticks. And these are what, give us a quick explainer of what a stop stick is, and then Adam's going to bring in why we're talking about it.
So stop stick is, I'm trying to think, it would be like an accordion.
Okay.
A really thin accordion with spikes in it that you would throw in front of a car. They drive over it, and the tires deflate, and then you pull over.
And then the suspect continues to drive on rims with sparks coming out.
But it takes timing.
Yes.
It takes timing with the squads that are chasing. It takes... Yeah, it's just one of those skill things that you have to do over and over and over and over and over, and it doesn't happen a lot.
So I'm glad you bring it up, because and credit to Ben Jordan over at TMJ4 News for doing digging on this chase that was a couple of years ago. We're going back in the archives to May of 2022 when police were pursuing a suspect for mobile drug dealing on the south side, started there, ended up on the freeway, hitting over 100 miles per hour, stop sticks deployed numerous times.
Ultimately, 17 of the 20 attempts missed the tires.
We need better training at this.
That's the audio of the pursuing squad. Ultimately,
as speeds slow down to less than 20 miles per hour, you can hear officers ask their supervisors if neighboring police departments can help.
Hey, closest behind us if they can come in and check.
Instead, MPD calls for more stop sticks, this time knocking out the main squad in pursuit.
We just got stop sticks, so we're going to need to have somebody take over primary.
So it's, I just find it interesting that everyone, you know, if you watch it in real time and you see them get it on the first nab, it's very important to know that is not always the case. This is far from a perfect science.
Of course not. And you're driving. How fast are you going at how many feet per second at 100 miles an hour? And then I have to throw the sticks out literally perfectly. So.
Well, and presumably there's other traffic, right? I mean, particularly if you're on the freeway. How do you know when is the suspect vehicle coming and exactly when you want to throw that out there so you're not throwing it in front of, you know, somebody's minivan?
Well, if I change lanes, then I can just avoid the stop stick.
So is this deployed by a vehicle?
No.
Like when you're moving?
By a person.
By a person, but who's already out stationary.
Who's already out, who's far enough ahead.
Yeah.
All those things have to line up right. So you can't, so.
How does this ever work?
I don't want to bash the officer, but. You know, if he were older, he probably would have thought it through because he's been in enough chases, been in enough things to know if the car's coming fast, you have to notify the primary car to slow down or change lanes or stop to not run over the stop sticks. So that's kind of on the driver of the squad car that ran over the stop sticks. So you really have to deploy them. They run over it and then you pull it out. Now, if that officer doesn't pull it back in time, that's on the officer.
And then now you've just blasted the squad that was was closest in the pursuit.
But there's no real wrong thing to do it. You just have to do it. It's repetitious. It's like firing a weapon. It's like using defensive and arrest tactics. It's vehicle operation. If you don't do it enough reps, you're not going to be good at it.
Right, and to that point, like, again, getting back to it, you assume just when you watch it that it's so easy, but it is not. This is something that clearly... You have to be experienced with it, and in real time, there's so many elements at play, too.
Well, you don't have time to really be experienced at it unless you're in a lot of chases, which means a lot of crashes, which means all those things. So it's kind of, it's a tool, but you have to use it in very, very specific. So if I'm in a street like Milwaukee where it's narrow and you can just throw the stop sticks out, and they run over it and pull it out, that's one thing. One lane traffic, all going in one direction. Highway, no, that doesn't make any sense.
Difference between training and actually being in a chase.
Yes, yes.
Real different scenarios, yes. Right? I mean, you can train and train and train, and that's great, but in that moment that all that training has to kick in, you're dealing with a different level of adrenaline, all of those things, right?
Well, training really gives you familiarity until you do it, right? It's a trained technique, but in the moment, it's really difficult to get it right.
Driving range versus the golf course, right? Oh, man, I was hitting them good on the range.
Yep.
Yeah, well, good
to
luck.
A picture. Oh, yeah, that's really great.
Great to see you, my friend.
Same
business
here.
Headlines are coming up next on Wisconsin's Morning News. Here's the Milwaukee Business Journal's Sean Ryan.
An $84 million medical campus is now under construction in Oshkosh for Frater Theta Care Health. The healthcare company continues talks with the city over sharing the costs of environmental cleanup work that's needed for the site. Versity Blood Research Institute aims to break ground this year on a $79 million expansion in Wauwatosa. A city design panel reviews the project next week. The Third Ward's Cafe Benelux reopens to the public on April 3rd after an extensive renovation that added a new wraparound bar and more booth seating. This is Sean Ryan with MilwaukeeBusinessJournal.com on News Radio WTMJ.
Hey boaters, cruise to Kendor Marine, we've got everything you need but the water. Got an old boat, a new boat, in between. Kendor Marine, upholstery and parts, hard to find things. Kendor Marine. Hey boaters, cruise to Kendor Marine, we've got everything you need but the water. Everything you need but the water. Hey boaters, cruise to Kendor Marine, we got everything you need but the water. Like a boat-loving kid in a candy store. Kendor Marine, if you have a question, we have the expertise at Kendor Marine. Hey boaters, cruise to Kendor Marine, we got everything you need but the water.
Easy to find at 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin or kendormarine.com.
Hey, it's WTMJ Steve Scafidi for Universal Windows Direct. I've been telling you that windows from Universal perform better and last longer. But let's talk about some of the other things they do that you might not know. Exclusive Unishield Supreme Siding delivers the warm, quality appearance of wood without the costly, time-consuming maintenance. How about their custom entry doors, available in over 12 different styles? Beauty, efficiency, and security. Clogged gutters can cause major damage to your home. Foundation problems, basement flooding, and more. With Universal Windows Direct, you'll never have to worry about cleaning your gutters again.
Who's faster, the Easter Bunny or O&H Danish Bakery? Ah, Kringle. Send that famous Kringle to any doorstep in just 2 business days. Serving Kringle will be the perfect Easter tradition. Pair that with their colorful and tasty Easter braided colored bread. Order your Easter treats online today. OHDanishBakery.com. Try all their delicious bakery made from scratch and hop into O&H Danish Bakery in Racine, Oak Creek, or Sturtevant this Easter season.
The place you want to go, Lynch McGuanago.
Nobody sells for less than Lynch.
Your trusted and relevant source for news, sports, traffic, and weather. We are Wisconsin's radio station. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
7 o'clock, I'm Vince Vetrano. This is Wisconsin's Morning News for Wednesday, March 27th. Our top story, a 6-year-old shot overnight in Milwaukee.
I'm Adam Roberts, a recovery mission underway in Baltimore.
I'm Debbie Lozaga, slowing down on 894 westbound through the construction zone, starting to slow down around 27th Street all the way to about 68th. We've also got northbound on 43 backing up from North Avenue all the way to Keefe. The rest of the system looking good. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic.
Decreasing clouds today, drying out in your storm team forecast. Cooler and breezy with a high of just 41 degrees. Tonight's low down to 25 under mostly clear skies. Milwaukee at 29, and from the WTMJ Breaking News Center, a child shot overnight Tuesday. Milwaukee police investigating this non-fatal shooting, 38th and Villard. A 6-year-old was taken to the hospital and expected to survive. What led up to that shooting still under investigation. Police say they are seeking unknown suspects.
Information downloaded from the data recorder aboard the container ship that caused Tuesday's bridge collapse in Baltimore is being sent back to the National Transportation Safety Board's lab for analysis. Federal investigators will board the ship later today. They have so far been unable to confirm that the vessel lost power just prior to the collision. NTSB Chair Jennifer Homendy tells ABC News they're still gathering that preliminary information.
We will be boarding the vessel at some point today to begin to look at the devastation, really, and then look through the vessel itself.
6 presumed dead construction workers in that incident.
And more on the Francis Scott Key Bridge collapse.
Marquette Assistant Engineer Professor Dr. Andrew Sin tells TMJ4 News bridges are usually built to withstand impacts, but not from a 900-foot cargo ship.
This is not going to happen every day. It shouldn't be a constant concern for people using bridges. There are very few bridges in the world where they could withstand a direct hit from an ocean-faring cargo ship. That's just an incredible amount of load.
He said says the more common bridge accidents in Milwaukee would be
maybe truck collisions with lower bridges. So we have see that a lot, say, in the downtown area of in Milwaukee. We have lots of rail bridges that are pretty low.
Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
If Waukesha County abandons its status as one of four Wisconsin counties without a half-cent sales tax, it could generate between $40 and $50 million in revenue. But not everything would go straight to the county budget. County Executive Paul Farrow tells Wisconsin's Afternoon News state statute requires reducing property taxes.
Ours is $1.39 right now per thousand. If we implement a sales tax, a portion of that money would have to go to property tax relief. Then we can look at the other areas and what we would do. That's why I want to put the task force together to really kind of chill out everything of what can happen and how we should go about it.
Farrow creating a task force of 40 municipal, business, and nonprofit leaders to study options like the sales tax for more revenue.
In a state where Republicans control the governor's mansion in both houses of the legislature, a Democrat has pulled off a win in Tuesday's special election. ABC's Jim Ryan telling us why activists on both sides of the abortion issue are taking notice.
Marilyn Lands made abortion and IVF access a central part of her campaign for a seat in the Alabama State House. Her campaign ads took a jab at supporters of former President Trump.
MAGA extremists are devising new and cruel ways to further erode our most basic freedoms.
Democrats at the national level see Lands' victory in yesterday's special election as a backlash against strict abortion statutes in GOP-dominated states like Alabama. Jim Ryan, ABC News.
Wisconsin's election coming up on Tuesday, April 2nd, and will include the presidential preference primary.
Coming up, controversy in the world of bacon.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 7:04.
This report is sponsored by Siding Unlimited. It's siding and a whole lot more. SidingUnlimited.com.
Your home's defense is crucial. Defensive failure is offensive to you. Siding Unlimited is your home's best defensive coach. Windows, roofing, decks, and of course, siding. Siding Unlimited is it. Windows? Siding Unlimited handles several great brands. They are one of only five Pella Platinum Premium installers in the whole country. The only one around here. Doors and decks, roofing, siding. Yes, 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 and yes. Nobody can beat Siding Unlimited. When you deal with Siding Unlimited, you'll get honest pricing, guaranteed. What is that? Well, no gimmicks, none of that BOGO, buy one now, get blah, 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 chin boogie. This is what it will cost you, period. Honest pricing. Bolster your home's defense with the best defensive team ever. SidingUnlimited.com.
St. Vincent de Paul Milwaukee has expanded into our new 76th and Bradley Road location, where thrifters will find hundreds of bargains on everything, from clothing to furniture, electronics, home goods, and more. Our inventory is always changing, and new deals pop up every day. We're accepting donations, too, at our convenient drive-through donation area. Help us help others. St. Vincent de Paul at 76th and Bradley Road in Milwaukee is now open.
Ooh, you're gonna love it, St. Vincent de Paul.
Hey, it's WTMJ's Steve Scafidi for the Bath Authority. If your bath or shower is old, outdated, has mold and mildew, broken tiles, you got to call my friends at the Bath Authority. The Bath Authority provides the highest quality bathroom remodeling products along with a world-class customer experience. Their modern durable tubs and showers are designed with an exclusive high-tech polymer liner. What that means to you? Low maintenance, resistance to mold and mildew, easy to clean, and lasts for decades. You're their priority at the Bath Authority. TheBathAuthority.com. A better bath awaits.
Are you tired of being tired? Go to AdventKnows.com.
Download the free Upside app to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code GIFT for an extra 25 cents per gallon on your first fill-up. That's promo code GIFT.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 7:06.
Bucks blow a big lead and stumble into overtime. We've got sports coming up at 7:15.
Speaking of sports, opening day for the Milwaukee Brewers less than 1 week away. In fact, official opening day coming up tomorrow. Brings more than baseball to the city every year.
Brewers VP of Community Relations, Katina Shaw, spent some time at spring training, but not to swing a bat. She's there to ask each player
what causes he like to support, some of the great things that they would like to do for the community when they come to Milwaukee.
And one of the biggest charity celebrations comes in May, an all-team effort called Kindness in Milwaukee.
It's a random act. A lot of the organizations don't even know we're coming. We either bring monetary donations or we'll purchase a bunch of items that's on their wish list.
Jessica Gatso, WTMJ News.
What does it take to be a cheese
taster. Stamina to start.
There's no better place for companies to test their cheese than the Center for Dairy Research at UW-Madison. Sensory coordinator Brandon Prochaska says cheese testers are taught a rigorous procedure.
We're spitting pretty much everything out. At the end of a long day, it gets pretty tiring, actually.
It starts with holding your nose before your first bite. Then there are more than a dozen aromas to identify.
Sour, sulfury, mushroomy.
Their work has made a difference.
We found some potential ways to make that squeak last a lot longer.
Julia Fellow, WTMJ News.
You might pair your cheese curds with a side of bacon, perhaps.
Yes,
but
please.
Be careful, as shocker, you can't believe everything you read on social media, even when it comes to that beloved breakfast meat.
An Instagram user who goes by Ken Guido Temprano is stirring up trouble about Aldi's bacon, claiming the Appleton Farms brand sold at the discount grocery chain doesn't come from pigs, but from pork grown in a lab. While the Canadian company called Appleton Meats has used animal cells to create milk, eggs, and meat, it is not affiliated with Massachusetts-based Appleton Farms, which clarifies its bacon is made the old-fashioned way. Straight from the pig. Deborah Rodriguez, CBS News.
Weirdly, now I want to visit Appleton, Wisconsin for some reason.
Right. Sports is coming up at 7:15. It's sponsored by Holiday Automotive at Highway 23 in Fond du Lac. Holiday Automotive, it's worth the trip.
Greg Mansick here for Holiday Mazda in Fond du Lac, where the Spring Forward sales event is your ticket to smile, save, and drive inspired this spring and beyond. Hey, right now, well-qualified buyers can lock in rates as low as 0% APR on favorites, including the exhilarating all-wheel drive Mazda CX-30 and CX-50 turbo models. Connect with Holiday and get more Mazda for your money and more for your trade on the new or Mazda-certified pre-owned car or crossover that's right for you. Choose from an impressive selection and enjoy Team Holiday's transparent, simplified buying approach and genuine guest care. It's the stuff that delights and makes fans of drivers from all over the Badger State. You'll be in great hands with Wisconsin's number one Mazda dealer and its number one Mazda certified pre-owned dealer on your side. Accolades are per Mazda North American Operations Performance and Zone Sales Records for 2023. Find yours and discover the difference at Holiday Mazda, Highway 41 and 23 in Fond du Lac, and online at holidaymazda.com. It's worth the trip.
7:09, what do you see on the roads, Deb?
Well, looks like we've got a broken down vehicle northbound 43 right about at Locust off on the left shoulder, so kind of in a weird spot. Got those delay spots right there anyway, so just be careful. Westbound on 894, backing up just east of Loomis all the way to about 68th Street. That's that construction delay. Everything else is looking pretty good, although volume's starting to pick up a little bit. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. High pressure builds into the area for the next couple of days. That gives us a quiet stretch of weather. We'll look for decreasing clouds today. Breezy winds with high temperatures in the upper 30s and lower 40s. Tonight, mostly clear and chilly. Low temperatures dropping into the 20s. Thursday, plenty of sunshine throughout the entire day with high temperatures in the mid-40s. Most of Friday will be dry. We'll look for increasing clouds. And then here comes our next low pressure system. That will bring rain chances Friday night into Saturday morning. High temperatures as we head towards the weekend will be in the 40s to low 50s. On Sunday, still keeping a small chance for an isolated rain shower with high temperatures in the mid-40s. I'm meteorologist Tyler Moore with the Storm Team Forecast on WTMJ.
Milwaukee at 28 degrees.
Live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee, this is Wisconsin's Morning News. Here's your host, Vince Vetrano.
7-Eleven on this Wednesday morning. Glad to have you with us. Supporters of former President Donald Trump in Wisconsin have been wondering, when are we going to see him again here in our state? A lot of high-profile visits from the Democratic side of the aisle. The president's been here twice in 3 months. Mm-hmm. The answer to that question on former President Trump, Tuesday. Former president set to visit Green Bay on Election Day.
His campaign says he'll be holding a rally at the Hyatt Regency Hotel and will speak at 5 o'clock.
Now, I could have told you that, but always nice to hear Susan Kim's voice here.
Thank you, Susan.
Yes. Not a lot of information outside of that on the event at this point from the Trump folks. Curious choice of venue. If you know Green Bay, the Hyatt Regency, it's a beautiful hotel. It's right downtown. It's just off the Fox River. It's got that huge atrium. So if you've ever gone up there, this is one of these where, like, you're in the middle of the hotel and there's like a skylight and then all the rooms, you can kind of see the, I don't want to call it a balcony, but, you know, they sort of open onto the atrium. So it's a really cool hotel in Green Bay. And it has adjacent space in the KI Convention Center, which is kind of part of the hotel. So it's got room, but it's not an arena.
Sure, and this kind of an event is going to attract quite the crowd for multiple reasons.
So I'm curious why the former president has chosen this as opposed to like the Resch Center, which is across from Lambeau Field. He surely could get a crowd of, you know, what, 10 plus thousand in there. This is a ticketed event, so there'll be a limited number of seats available. Don't have a number for you, but you imagine those would be snatched up rather quickly.
The thing that comes to mind for me maybe is that this, because this is coming so quickly, the announcement made yesterday, it's happening a week later, that's a quick turnaround. I have to wonder if it was going to be planned at the Resch or some other bigger venue, if there's more planning out that would need to take place. Maybe there's something going on this particular day. I have to imagine that Trump wanted to be here on election day. I feel like that date is also very important.
It's the date of the presidential preference primary as well as our municipal elections for the spring general. So it'll be the president's former president's first visit to the state since 2022. He was last year in Waukesha campaigning for Tim Michels, who at the time was running for governor. Trump rally Green Bay at the Hyatt Regency Hotel, April 2nd. 7:13, Wisconsin's Morning News. We got sports coming up next.
You know, most mulch is reclaimed from landfills, but Erickson's mulch is ground from whole trees. Yep, we process the mulch ourselves to keep the prices nice and low and use only premium colorant so the beautiful look of new mulch lasts. At Erickson's, we never skimp. And that's why first-time shoppers become repeat customers. Erickson's Landscape Supply. High-quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less. Commercial or residential, visit ericsonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection. How do we keep our prices so low? That's easy. We've removed the middlemen. Yep, most landscape suppliers have a couple of them in there. And that's okay. But each one of those men in the middle means a higher cost for your mulch, decorative stone, flagstone, and boulders. Feel free to check around. For the quality of our products, you won't find better prices. Erickson's Landscape Supply. High-quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less. Commercial or residential, visit ericsonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry. Semper Fi.
SemperFiRoofing.com.
Now, time for a sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All sports desk. Here's Greg Hill.
Yeah, it was the Lakers in town yesterday at Pfizer Forum. What once was a 19-point lead held by the Bucks turned into a tie game in the fourth quarter. 101 apiece, Lakers running an out-of-bounds play.
Taking it into Reeves, he fires up the three. Oh, he almost banked it in. It rimmed out, and we go to overtime.
Yeah, okay, free basketball. Who doesn't love free basketball, right?
Might as well have banked it in, given the result you're about to share.
Well, 117-117 at the end of the first overtime, except this time, the Bucks have the ball.
Inbound pass goes to Dame. Dame takes it inside, scoops the shot up. It's blocked by Davis. Anthony Davis protects the scoreboard, and we're going to double overtime.
Yeah, double OT. Who ordered it? Fresh off the plate for you. Trading buckets back and forth. What a game, but what spelled the end for the Bucks.
Now they get it to Reeves. Open three, and he drills it. Lakers by three with 37.8 seconds to go.
So LeBron James didn't play, but it looks like he put on an Austin Reeves jersey because that kid had a game last night. Couple free throws later and
bing, that's the end of that. You know, it's the only thing he can say.
Yeah, Bucks follow the Lakers in double OT, 128-124. Super fun game. Not a fun result, though. Next up for the Bucks, they head to New Orleans to take on the Pelicans on Thursday. And speaking of Thursday, Brewers opening up their regular season in New York against the Mets. For what it's worth, the Brewers fell in their last spring training game to the Rockies, but spring training's over. None of that matters now, because now it starts to count. 162-game season starts Thursday in New York. They have a 12-10 first pitch scheduled. What's also scheduled for 12-10 in Queens? So much of it. I've seen 92%. I've seen 97%. Looks like there's going to be rain, but not calling anything yet, just something to kind of be aware of. That's why MLB has the off day the day after the home or the season opener, so they will have that Friday open if they need to play. Not calling anything yet, but just something to keep your eye on.
I'm looking it up. I got it right here.
All right, look up that radar
for
me.
App
all right.
For whatever that's worth.
Okay.
And looks like it's raining all morning. This is projecting 24.
So, it can rain all morning, right? I mean, you throw the tarp on, and then come 11:30, you know, local time, maybe they can take it off. It'll be dry and field.
Yeah, but if it's like that monsoony rain for like hours and hours, that outfield is...
Yeah, it's not looking great with the band of blue that's going across the East Coast right now. It's scheduled to go there for tomorrow. So, again, we will keep an eye on it. Hey, either way, all season long, we're your home of your Brewers, WTMJ.
Hey, coming up next...
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
May the 4th is coming up. How Marcus Theaters in particular have a very distinct honor to celebrate the Star Wars franchise. That is coming up next. We'll talk live with Greg Marcus, president and CEO of Marcus Corporation, the movies guy. He joins us on Wisconsin's Morning News live next.
I'm Sandy Max, host of WTMJ's What's on Tap. Weeknights at 6, you're invited to join me for conversations about culture and creativity in Wisconsin and around the world.
Well, for the first time ever, we are serving St. Patrick's Cream Puff.
Discover and rediscover music, theater, film, food, and topics that are unique to our state.
As of today, we've announced that Milwaukee Film will be taking over Operation at the Downer.
It's your hour-long escape from the ordinary. What's on Tap on WTMJ and wherever you get your podcasts.
Hey there, Eric Bilstead for Tri-County Contracting. It's your go-to company, you know the ones, for the worry-free roof tune-up. They extend the life of your roof. But not only that, Tri-County Contracting does offer an exclusive 1110 program. What it means is after roofing your house, Chuck and the crew will offer 11 inspections over 10 years for free. Routine maintenance for a decade for free. Learn more about the 1110 program on their website, tricountycontractingwi.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here. If you're like me, my home has become my happy place. It's happier now thanks to CertaPro Painters. They are simply the best in the business. They will take care of the scuffs, the faded colors. They'll make your home a new home, inside or outside. They did the work at our house. It was quick, easy, and so, so affordable. Their estimates are always easy. You get a quote right away. It's simply the best in the business. Schedule your free estimate online at CertaPro.com. That's Certa with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters.
At Uline, they know firsthand the road to success is an uphill climb. Uline started in the family basement, and through hard work is now North America's most trusted shipping and industrial supplier. They get what it means to have the support of reliable, hardworking partners. So they keep 41,000 items ready to ship. Whether your company is still in a basement office or expanding cross-country, Uline will be there on your road to success. Visit Uline.com.
Traffic is sponsored by the Amazing Mineshaft Restaurant in downtown Hartford.
Take your family to the super affordable all-you-can-eat Easter brunch at the Amazing Mineshaft Restaurant in beautiful downtown Hartford. Kids under 3 eat free. MineshaftRestaurant.com.
Checking in on your traffic situation here with Debbie.
All right. Well, we got a little bit of a backup on westbound 894 between Loomis and 68th Street through that construction zone. Everywhere else seems to be looking pretty good. We're not seeing any other major delays around the area. Volume's picking up, but it's really not slowing anything down right now. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Painting Time Saver Traffic.
Deb, what's the most Star Wars movies you've watched, like, in a row? You ever gone back to back to back? Or?
I think I did the original three back to back to back. So
several hours invested. Good
for you. Mm-hmm. But that's it. I mean, I've never done nine.
Do you want to try all nine?
If I see, I'm
right.
Like, my weekends are too valuable to me, so that's like a weekend and like a long weekend.
Tell you about that next here in a moment. First, let me get you your Storm Team forecast. Decreasing clouds today, cooler and breezy, high of 41. Tonight's low down to 25. Mostly sunny on Thursday. Thursday's high 45 degrees. The sunshine will feel good. 46 degrees your high temperature at the lake on Friday. A little bit warmer inland with increasing clouds and a chance for rain late. For your weekend, chance of morning showers on Saturday. 55 inland, bit cooler near the lake. And Sunday, a slight chance of a shower under mostly cloudy skies and a high of 44 degrees. Milwaukee's at 29. May 4th becoming a bigger and bigger deal.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
Increasingly known as Star Wars Day, as folks are wont to say, may the 4th be with you. Disney, which now owns, of course, the Star Wars franchise, is leaning in hard on all that.
Why not? Do or do not. There is no try.
Well, they're trying super hard. Special screenings part of this year's May 4th celebration. One of them, a marathon, the Ultimate Star Wars Galaxy Party. And in Wisconsin, it will be held exclusively at Marcus Majestic Cinema in Waukesha. Tell us a little bit more about that and other fun offerings. President and CEO of Marcus Corporation, Greg Marcus, is live with us on the Tri-County Contracting Hotline this morning.
With 900 years old, you reach, look as good, you will not.
Oh, come on. Yeah, that's not nice. Greg's not 900. Great to talk with you, Greg. It's a Yoda burn for you to start.
Oh my God. Now, you know, actually, you know something really depressing? I was sort of reading, they give me some talking points and I'm reading through them and I remember they pointed out we're playing, not only are we doing this marathon that we're going to talk about, we're playing Phantom Menace, the episode one. And it's the 25th anniversary of episode one. And I'm thinking, 25th anniversary, did they get the episode number confused? Because, you know, for those in the know, they started with episode 4, which was the first, you know, the first set, the original Star Wars. I'm thinking, how old am I? Oh, no, that was so long ago.
Right there with you, my friend. Really, I mean, when they said 25th anniversary, I knew the re-release of Phantom Menace was coming out. When they said 25th anniversary, I was like, that can't be right. Somebody did the math wrong, please.
Yeah, so yeah, I'm not 900, but I'm old enough to remember actually the first one, episode 4.
Well, let's talk about this exclusive party that you're able to throw. You're screening Star Wars 1 through 9 in that order, starting with The Phantom Menace. This is an overnighter, May 3rd into May 4th. Like, when we were kids, I guess, like, is it a lock-in? Right? All the kids come and nobody gets to leave?
No, I think that would be against a bunch of codes.
Okay, they can leave what they want, but who would?
Yeah, why? Once you've made that investment, and like, what do you like? Once you're, and it's got to be like the fork in the road thing, like where you go to the right, you think, well, maybe I should have, you know, gone to the left. When it's 4 a.m, you're like, whoa, but I'm here. So,
do you have any tickets left for that, Greg? I know, I think it's $45, right, for the whole deal, and then along with that, there are some extras included for you and discounts on concessions because you'll need it. You're in for the duration. Any tickets left to that exclusive event?
Yeah, actually, you know, the interesting thing is it was so popular that we actually opened up a second screen of it. So there are a few tickets left if you want to get them, but I suspect those will be gone as well. So you gotta hop on and get in.
So why were you chosen? Why did Disney offer you and the Majestic in particular this exclusive opportunity?
You know, I think because we're one of the best theater companies in the country, and we're known for having great facilities, great presentation. I mean, you're going to have at one of our premier theaters, and all of our theaters are great, obviously, but the Majestic is really one of our premier theaters in our entire circuit. And they know that we'll take great care of our guests, so they trust us. It is about trust.
Greg, I'm going over the themed breakfast menu for the offering that people will get, and I'm partial to the Dex's Diner Space Waffles with blue batter. So what other things can people expect on this exclusive menu?
You know, I think that probably the most important thing on the menu, I look at the menu too, is going to be the Palpatine Farms Vine Coffee. Don't you think you're going to need a lot of coffee?
Palpatine Farms, that's good stuff.
Is it farm to table, though?
Straight from the farm.
Well, so let's go back to Phantom Menace. The re-release of that comes out, and I know you got some extra fun things. Like, you know, we talk about how moviegoers have changed their expectations, and increasingly you got to do more than just say we've got a really big screen, which you do, and that's wonderful. But outside of that, one thing that I admire that you've been doing is turning things more into an event. I can watch The Phantom Menace at home, but what I can't do is watch The Phantom Menace with a guy next to me who's wearing a Stormtrooper outfit and other fans and have that community experience to go see these films that we love.
Vince, you actually pointed out, I think, one of the most important things about movie going, and actually even, although eventizing is really important, and getting people to dress up in amazing costumes is fantastic, and it just adds to it and all the things that we're doing around it. It's nothing new. It's called showmanship. We've been doing it for years. We try to make it fun when you come to the movies. But the idea of being with other people, I don't care if it's Star Wars, or if it's a smaller film like American Fiction, it's not as much of an event. The idea is to be with other people. The one thing you can't do at home, you can watch with other people at home, but it just isn't the same. You know, you aren't in, because the other person, someone's probably sitting on their phone. Someone's going to, you know, it's just a different experience. And so going out and being with by the way, you're not going to put hundreds of other people in your home. I mean, you might, but, you know, then you got to feed them. So,
no interest in that. Greg Marcus is president and CEO of Marcus Corp. Greg, I know you got a couple of fun things coming up for Easter weekend as well.
Got to hop to the movies, absolutely. It's on March 30th at 10 a.m., moviegoers can visit the Easter Bunny, go on an Easter egg hunt, participate in crafts, all sorts of fun things. We're gonna show, you know, Easter Classic Hop or Migration, the new one. It's a new family favorite. So we got it in every location except the campus throughout Wisconsin.
Always great to catch up with you, Greg. We will see you at the movies.
Yep, love it. Take care.
May the Force be with you always.
Remember, the Force will be with you always.
Dow Jones Industrial Average down 31 points in the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update to 39,282. The NASDAQ was down nearly 70 points in trading on Tuesday to 16,316. And the S&P 500 closed at 5204. That was off about 14.5 points. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite Financial Planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com. It's a trap! Welcome to the Knowledge Brokers, weekly feature covering the dynamics of the insurance market and how it affects Wisconsin businesses and folks who live here. Sponsored by the original Knowledge Brokers, R&R Insurance. And joining us today is Jeff Salasinski. He's Vice President of Insurance Operations. Good to see you again, Jeff. We've been talking a lot on the news lately about these huge settlements and jury awards that are happening in court. I know that's something that's on your radar.
Yeah, thank you, Vince. It's great to be here. Business owners and individuals need to know the courts are open. They've been largely closed for a couple of years following the pandemic. You're seeing attorney advertising everywhere. It's attacking virtually every industry. These excessive awards and settlements are becoming less shocking. People are just simply becoming desensitized to some of these huge numbers.
So what's any of that got to do with insurance then?
So both inflation and legal system abuse that we've been speaking of may have already rendered your insurance limits inadequate.
Okay, this is the insurance I have right now. You're saying not enough to cover potential damages.
Correct. You might see one of these big numbers against your company as a business owner, perhaps against you as an individual in an auto accident. If you had $500 or $1 million a few years ago, it might not be enough today.
Okay, lots of folks do insurance. Why is R&R Insurance the company to count on?
It's really important to work with an insurance professional that understands these issues like R&R. You need in-depth analysis on today's risks and how they impact your business and you as an individual. R&R can help you make a data-driven decision to make sure the selections you're making are adequate. Today's environment is incredibly dynamic, as we've spoken for on our previous engagements. It's rapidly changing. You need a partner that understands what's going on, what's important, and how you manage risk and finding a solution in this market.
That's Jeff from R&R Insurance. Great info as always, Jeff. More information online at myknowledgebroker.com.
We've got some problems along westbound 894, basically from about 27th Street all the way to Forest Home. Otherwise, everything else is moving along well. Debbie Lozago with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Decreasing clouds, cooler and breezy today. High of just 41 degrees. Right now, Milwaukee at 28.
ABC News, I'm Sherry Preston. The six construction workers missing after the collapse of the Key Bridge in Baltimore are now presumed to have died. The bridge falling apart after being slammed by a cargo ship early Tuesday. The investigation goes on into what caused the crash, but the economic impacts of the bridge collapse are becoming clear.
More than $80 billion in cargo passes through this port every year, and now shipping and logistics companies are scrambling to find other options to move these massive containers. Shipping in and out of the port is suspended indefinitely through vessel traffic. Cruise ships that were supposed to leave from here are now rerouting to Virginia instead.
ABC's Elizabeth Schulze in Baltimore. A Texas law that allows the state to arrest and deport possibly migrants suspected of being in the U.S. illegally will remain on hold for now, thanks to a new ruling today by the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals. Only one winning ticket sold for last night's $1 billion Mega Millions jackpot in the state of New Jersey.
This is ABC News.
Signing Unlimited WTMJ News Time 7:31.
From the WTMJ Breaking News Center this morning, a child shot in Milwaukee late Tuesday night. Police investigating. Child is expected to survive. Happened at 38th and Villard. Six-year-old taken to the hospital. What led up to that shooting still under investigation. Police say they are seeking unknown suspects.
A federal lawsuit has accused a Milwaukee Public Schools principal of abusing a first grader for having gay parents. Former assistant principal at Milwaukee French Immersion School, Kasongo Kalambula, allegedly told the student his parents would, quote, burn in hell, and allegedly at one point threatened to kill the student if he told anyone about the abuse. The complaint says Kalambula would lock the student referred to as GL in a dark room for hours and failed to protect GL from other students who were bullying them. Now, despite allegations, Kalambula was promoted to acting principal of the school, later leaving to become principal of Mary McLeod Bethune Academy, where they still work at to this day.
Waukesha County considering adding a half-cent sales tax to keep funding big-ticket budget items like its sheriff's department. County Executive Paul Farrell on Wisconsin's Afternoon News saying the consideration is not because Milwaukee County increased its sales tax.
We're in a different position. Waukesha County, third largest county, we have the lowest spending of any county in the state per person. So I think we're very fiscally prudent, but we still have high level of services. We've been able to balance that out. The challenges come in. We're capped by how much property levy we can have.
And Waukesha, one of only four counties in Wisconsin that does not levy that half-cent sales tax. Farrell also adding Ozaukee County, the only county in the state with a lower tax rate than Waukesha.
It shouldn't take a tragedy to bring community together like this and keep community together like this, but that's what happened.
Tragedy struck in Oak Creek when a gunman opened fire on the Wisconsin Sikh temple about 12 years ago, killing six people. Pradeep Kalika tells Wisconsin's Midday News his father was one of those six. He's since been on a mission to help his community heal from the effects. However, he wishes Wisconsin would take more initiative to prevent hate crimes.
Creating infrastructure around hate crime prevention, or sometimes what we call targeted violence prevention, we're a little bit behind. Illinois is obviously working on creating infrastructure. I was just in Providence, Rhode Island. They are creating infrastructure to address hate.
You can hear the entire conversation over at WTMJ.com or wherever you get your podcasts.
You know your Splenda from your Stevia. Non-nutritive sweeteners have become just as commonplace as artificial substitutes for cane sugar. But new studies suggest that even these plant-derived sugar substitutes, they have health implications. President and CEO of the Medical College of Wisconsin, Dr. John Raymond, on Wisconsin's Afternoon News.
Beverages that contain non-nutritive sweeteners increase the risk of atrial fibrillation by 20%. Sweeteners with natural sweeteners increase the risk by 10%. And to put it into perspective, that 20% risk with non-nutritive sweeteners was with just one can of soda per day.
And Dr. Raymond adding, non-nutritive sweeteners often increase sugar cravings, which of course can lead to weight gain, which of course is why you started taking the non-nutritive sweeteners in the first place.
You can't win.
When's the magic sweetener? That's what we want. Just nothing. Still
probably
found it,
a couple
right?
decades out.
Traffic is sponsored by Sendix Food Market, your trusted local grocer since 1926.
Don't miss Sendix Seafood Spectacular this Thursday through Saturday. Great deals like premium wild-caught halibut fillets, just $9.99 per pound. Sendix, your trusted local grocer.
Coming up, a well-known boxing icon focusing on ear-based branding.
Signing Unlimited, WTMJ News Time 7:35.
This report is sponsored by Diamonds Direct. Your love, their passion.
Hey, honey, I'm home.
Bob, I just hung up with Joe. It's the fourth time he's called this week. He says he's worried because for the first time in 12 years, you didn't buy my anniversary jewelry from him.
You didn't tell him, did you?
No, I didn't tell him how we made the switch to Diamonds Direct and how much I love my new diamond ring or these incredible diamond stud earrings you got me either.
Bob's gonna go nuts when he finds out. But I can't believe how all these things he used to say about Diamonds Direct just aren't true. And the prices are a lot better than his.
Yeah, and what I love is the free service at Diamonds Direct. I can get my jewelry cleaned anytime. And everyone there is like family.
Are you getting all you deserve from your jeweler? You might be surprised. Maybe it's time to make the switch to Diamonds Direct for guaranteed better value, selection, service, and quality.
If he comes up on the caller ID, just don't answer it.
All right, but we can't keep dodging him. You know we're going to see him at the family reunion.
Yeah, I know.
Diamonds Direct. No middleman, no pricing games, no compromises. Get details and showroom directions at DiamondsDirect.com.
Griffin is your one-stop shop this March. For just $179.95, enjoy an oil change
tire rotation, air filter, wiper blades, multi-point inspection, battery check, and heat inspection. North, south, or west, wherever you are in town, Griffin guarantees to cover your automotive needs. Call or visit us today for details and restrictions. Griffin, your spring drive starts here.
Ridiculous fees, robocalls, customer service that's lacking the actual service. It sounds like you might be getting bullied by your bank. You don't have to settle. At Wintrust, we take a different approach. Whether you need banking solutions, a new home, or help planning your financial future, Wintrust has local experts ready to lend a hand. Stop banking the same way, expecting different results, and start banking where you matter at wintrust.com/bullyfree. Wintrust, different approach, better results. Banking products provided by Wintrust Financial Corp. Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 7:37.
Brewers wrap spring training, looking ahead to opening day in sports at 7:45.
It was nearly 27 years ago, former boxing champ Mike Tyson famously bit part of the ear of Evander Holyfield off, spit it out, and then went back in for a second round. Well, now Tyson hoping to cash in from that moment.
Mike Tyson biting Holyfield in the right ear.
Hot shops in New York are selling Tyson-branded edibles shaped like an ear with a bite mark, harkening back to his bloody showdown with Evander Holyfield in 1997. Tyson's credited cannabis with improving his mental well-being. The New York Post says he's planning a promotional blitz for his new gummies at an event in Times Square next month. The former heavyweight champ is also planning a comeback fight against Jake Paul in July. Deborah Rodriguez, CBS News,
and
New York.
You really can brand just about anything.
I would watch that fight, I'll tell you that much. Iron Mike, what's going to happen?
And Jake Paul, he's no slouch. Jake Paul, most people know him as the influencer, the Vine guy, the TikTok guy, whatever, but he's built up a pretty solid boxing career for himself. By the way...
So you think Mike's getting beat?
No, I'm never going to bet on Iron Mike. I will never bet against Iron Mike. By the way, if you're on trying to find those gummies, keep an eye out for them. They will soon be in a store near you called Mike Bites.
I was not trying to find those gummies. News is sponsored by Annex Wealth Management's Money Talk. That's heard Saturdays at 10 right here on WTMJ.
Like it or not, you are a media-consuming machine, chased all day by headlines, texts, emails, on the TV, the computer, the phone, even your smartwatch. News about market volatility and uncertainty could lead to anxiety and planning paralysis. No surprise, Americans report increased stress about their investment and retirement plans. This isn't a time to be frozen in place. Take action. Put Annex Wealth Management on your side. Build a plan that will help cut through the noise. We'll provide comprehensive investment and retirement guidance that includes tax and estate planning. Let Annex do a deep dive on your portfolio, offer unbiased advice with Wealthmetric, and work to create a solid plan for you and your family. Turn down the media roar. Dial up the planning. Head to AnnexWealth.com and click the Get Started button. It takes only a couple of minutes. Set your own appointment. In person or online, it's time to take action and know the difference with a fee-only fiduciary. That's Annex Wealth Management. AnnexWealth.com.
I'm Jim Tolkien, president of the Auto Dealers Association of Metro Milwaukee. There are so many reasons to service your car or truck and buy your next vehicle at one of the 115 ATOM member dealers. ATOM dealers employ more than 7,500 people in southeastern Wisconsin, which helps support thousands of local families. ATOM also contributes to many local charities. For example, ATOM recently completed their Change Your Oil, Change Lives promotion, benefiting Feeding America Eastern Wisconsin. Over the past 14 years, they've raised over $875,000, which provided more than 2.6 million meals to people in southeast Wisconsin, the majority being children and seniors. These are just a few reasons to service your car or truck and buy your next vehicle from an ATOM member dealer instead of a national online company with no ties to our community. To find an ATOM member dealer, visit ATOM.com. That's ADAMM.com.
20 to 8. What do you see on the roads, Deb?
Well, we got some delays along westbound 94, about from 25th Street all the way through to Mitchell Boulevard. Eastbound side slowing down just a bit coming out of the stadium interchange. Southbound 43, slowing from Hampton Avenue all the way down past Keefe. Northbound side's a little bit tight past that spot as well. And then, of course, westbound 894, slow out of the Mitchell interchange all the way to Forest Home. We're looking at about a 9-minute ride between the Mitchell and the Hale, an extra 3. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. All the rain is behind us, and now we'll see more sunshine as we work through the day today with decreasing clouds and high temperatures in the upper 30s and lower 40s. Breezy winds out of the west will continue for today. Tonight, mostly clear skies and chilly, low temperatures dropping into the 20s. Plenty of sunshine for Thursday with high temperatures in the mid-40s. Most of Friday will be dry with increasing clouds. Then rain chances return Friday night into Saturday morning. High temperatures as we head towards the week will be in the 40s to low 50s. Sunday, a slight chance for an isolated rain shower. Mostly cloudy with high temperatures in the mid-40s. I'm meteorologist Tyler Moore at the Storm Team Forecast on WTMJ.
Milwaukee temp at 28 degrees. At 7:42 on Wisconsin's Morning News. Admit, not all these stories are created equal. You have some sort of, we call it in the news business, localizing. So there's some major national or international event, and then you try to find a way to make that event connected to something local. And some of those stories are very worthwhile and others not. This one of the could it happen here variety as we talk about the epic bridge collapse in Baltimore. Search for six people now presumed dead, suspended. A cargo ship slammed into the bridge support structure that toppled the whole thing. So, quick story. When I was at 4 one time, there was I think it was the sarin gas attack in one of the subway systems out east. And I don't think it even occurred on a train itself. It was in sort of the system when you're underground and things like that. Mm-hmm. And there was we should do it. Could it happen here? And I said, if you put me on that story, when they toss to me and say, Vince Vitrano's live with the could it happen here, we don't have a subway, so no, back to you.
Almost did, but okay. No, we do not.
So, no. But asking questions about our bridge structure, about our harbor, I think that's fair given what happened out east. Local port officials, first responders, they've been talking about it.
If we had something like that here, it would be kind of an all hands type of an event. Part of their morning conversation was just talking about the bridge and the response and some of the things they would do. Get you kind of thinking about some new things.
So that's Skylar Belot. He's assistant chief of operations for Milwaukee Fire. He was talking with TMJ4's Mary Jo Ola. Said, yeah, came up at the morning meeting. Are we prepared? What's our critical response? Should we be in touch with the crews that have responded to this out east once things settle down? Are there any tips and things that we need to learn about and take into account as we talk about protecting the Hone, some of our other structures in the port? Now, the Hone Bridge is different than what has happened out here in Baltimore, just because if you look through the straight cut, as they call it, the piers aren't in the water.
Right.
The support piers are actually on land that cover that span.
I think the more real-world application, if you're looking for one in our area, and we heard from the professor at Marquette University in the news earlier, when you're thinking about bridges, the more realistic potential bad situation could be if you drive anywhere around Milwaukee, there are some of those low hangers, we call them the can openers. You have those trucks go over those overpasses that are maybe just a little bit too close for comfort. So I think that's maybe a more real-world application than a 900-foot cargo ship barreling into the Hone, which is just not going to happen because those giant ships just don't come to Port Milwaukee.
Yeah, Port of Milwaukee releasing a statement. I'll let Mary Jo Ola, again from Ford, tell you what they had to say.
In a statement, Port Milwaukee officials say the area does not receive ships as large as the one involved in the Baltimore incident. They say the ones that use Port Milwaukee are similar in length but half as wide.
So could it happen here exactly like it played out in Baltimore? Unlikely, but good to know. The people who need to know the answer to that question are on top of it. And we are going to get a live update from ABC News at 20 to 9 this morning about the situation in Baltimore, specifically where the investigation stands this morning. We'll talk live with ABC News correspondent Derek Dennis, who's been on this following the latest on the investigation from the get-go. That comes up at 20 minutes before 9 this morning. Sports is up next.
Hey, Eric Bilstead here from Wisconsin's Morning News. So you're thinking about hitting the gym, eh? Or perhaps taking up jogging again, but you're worried. That achy knee, am I right? And you have no interest in surgery. Call QC Kinetics now. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. No surgery, no drugs, no downtime. So that means getting back to exercising, maybe even running, or even playing 18 holes again. Pain-free. QC Kinetics offers an all-natural solution, no pain pills, and no risky surgery. Reclaim your mobility today. Fix that tennis swing or go back to the gym and know that you won't be dealing with achy joints afterward. Take action now and live your best life this spring and summer. Call QC Kinetics for a free consultation. QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. QC Kinetics.
Now, time for a sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. Here's Greg Hill.
Yeah, so the Lakers came to town last night. They were LeBron-less. I mean, he was there. He was just not suited up for the game. And what was a 19-point lead at one point in the second half turned into a tie game in the fourth quarter. The score, 101-101. Lakers running an out-of-bounds play and...
they get it into Reeves. He fires up the three. Oh, he almost banked it in. It rimmed out, and we go to overtime.
Yes, we do. We're in overtime, through overtime, at the end of overtime. 117-117. One final play. This time, the Bucks have the ball.
Inbound pass goes to Dame. Dame takes it inside. Scoops the shot up. It's blocked by Davis. Anthony Davis protects the scoreboard, and we're going to double overtime.
Double overtime is right. Trading buckets back and forth. What a game, but what spelled the end.
Now they get it to Reeves. Open three, and he drills it. Lakers by three with 37.8 seconds to go.
And that would be it. The Bucks fall to the Lakers in double OT, 128-124. Fun game, not a fun result. Next up for the Bucks, they head to New Orleans to take on the Pelicans on Thursday. Speaking of Thursday, that's when the Brewers will open the regular season. For what it's worth, Brewers fall in their last spring training game yesterday, but that doesn't matter because it's spring training, so it's all over, all done with. It's a 162-game season. It starts on Thursday against the Mets in New York, and not to be that guy, but I'm about to be. The forecast around noon at Citi Field tomorrow, it looks
like rain.
Yeah, and a lot of it. Come on, Alanis. A lot of it, though. So we'll see. Again, MLB institutes that one off day following the opener, and that is Friday, so we could possibly be playing on Friday. Nothing official yet, but just something to keep your eye on. We'll get some Packers Nuggets out of the way. They got a kicker. Look out, Anders Carlson. Greg Joseph is gunning for your job, signing to the green and gold yesterday. The team also reportedly beginning preliminary discussions on a contract extension with quarterback Jordan Love. Love becomes an unrestricted free agent in 2025, and the rumor mill turns on the possibility of the Packers being the opponent to the Eagles on the week one game of the season opener in Brazil this year. That game on Friday, September 6th. The Packers, they have a reputation of being a global brand, so I wouldn't be surprised if they get the draw. Again, just rumors now, but something to monitor.
You know, one of the bigger stories to come out of the, is it the coaches' meetings or the owners' meetings? It's coaches'
They're
meetings,
all together,
right?
Yep.
What's going on now is Packers seem to be going public about their discussions with the city of Green Bay about a long-term lease at Lambeau Field, and apparently those conversations are not at this point going well. We're going to explore what's going on there in Green Bay about the Packers and their future in that city coming up at 8:10 this morning. 7:49, Wisconsin's Morning News.
According to the U.S. debt clock, our debt is over $32 trillion in climbing. The question is, how do we pay it off? One of the most likely answers is increasing taxes. Now think about your retirement accounts. Do you want to pay taxes on some of that money now when rates are historically low, or later when rates are potentially higher? At Drake & Associates, we can help you create a plan so your retirement is tax efficient as possible. If you'd like to continue your education, we have our Retirement Ready Toolkit, which includes guides on retirement tax savings. To receive this complimentary toolkit, call or text TAX to 414-409-9982. That's calling or texting TAX to 414-409-9982. When taxes go up, will you be ready? Call or text now.
Investment advisory services provided by Drake & Associates, LLC, an SEC-registered investment advisor. Insurance products are offered through a separate company, Loft Financial Advisory Group, LLC, a Wisconsin insurance agency. Clients are under no obligation to purchase any recommended insurance products.
How much does it cost to talk to Gruber Law Offices after a serious crash? It's free. Yes, free. As in, it won't cost you anything to speak with us. Not sure if you have a case? Call our team at Gruber Law Offices today. Your first call and your first consultation are always free. And you'll never pay us a fee until we win your case. If you've been seriously injured, call Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Traffic is sponsored by Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee. Milwaukee Mattress, where top quality mattresses are priced hundreds less than premium national mattress brands. Found exclusively at Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, and downtown Milwaukee.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Checking in with Debbie here at 9 minutes before 8.
All right, northbound 43, still a bit backed up from North Avenue up towards Keith. There is a broken down vehicle in the left shoulder right about at Locust, still causing some issues. Southbound side is going to be slow just before Hampton Avenue down past Keith. Westbound 94, you're seeing delays from about 25th Street all the way to Mitchell Boulevard. Eastbound starting to slow down just a bit as you're making your way in from just before Holly Road all the way through the stadium. 894 westbound, still going to be a bit of a heavy ride. 8 minutes to get from the Mitchell to the Hale. Most of those delays happening through the construction zone at Loomis from the Mitchell all the way to about 68th Street. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
WTMJ forecast sponsored by Dave Dre Camp Heating, where your comfort is their family's tradition. High of just 41 degrees today. At least we're drying out. Low down to 25 tonight under mostly clear skies. Sunshine on Thursday, high of 45. Friday's high 46 at the lake, 53 inland with a chance of rain moving in late. Chance of morning showers on Saturday, 50 at the lake, 55 inland for your high. And for Sunday, Easter Sunday, slight chance of a shower, mostly cloudy, high 44. Right now at 29 in Milwaukee. Milwaukee Brewers open the 2024 season tomorrow, weather permitting, in New York City. Brewers opening day at home. The home opener, that's coming up next week.
Put away the snowplow and come on out!
Yeah, right. We're in New York City to face the Mets. 12-10 in a first pitch from City Stadium tomorrow. Again, weather permitting.
Onward towards a World Series.
A little early to say that, Uke, but appreciate the optimism. All this week, getting you set for baseball. Our third interview in the series.
Back to back to back!
All right.
Nice.
Joined this morning by the executive director of the Brewers Community Foundation, Cecilia Gore. Great to talk with you, Cecilia.
Good morning. How are you doing?
You know, I know you and the foundation, you do your work year-round, you're active all year, but it's got to be great to have baseball now just a day away, right? Things get more exciting around there?
They really do. We get a chance to engage with our fans at every home game, and there's just a new level of excitement.
So one of the reasons that I believed so strongly in the value of the taxpayer-funded stadium deal that will keep the Brewers here for another generation is in part at least because of the work that you and the foundation do. More than $4 million raised in 2023, and more than 200 nonprofit organizations that you support every year.
Well, we feel strongly that we're a part as a team of the fabric of this community. And so we want to do our part to engage with fans and people that live in this community and try to make a difference. So I'm very proud of Brewers Community Foundation and our work. We focus on health, education, recreation, and basic needs, and really just try to seek out opportunities to help.
And to that end, Cecilia, you've got a pretty big event coming up today. A lot of work going to be done with some packages for families facing home insecurity.
Yeah, we are going to work with our employees this morning, and we're going to put together, I think, 1,000 care packages for 5 organizations: the Dominican Center, Pathfinders, Cathedral Center, Latina Resource Center at UMOS, and Center for Vet Issues. And each one of those organizations will get a grant for $5,000. And then our employees are putting together those 200 care packages just as a gesture to say that we appreciate what you're doing and look forward to working with you throughout the season.
We're talking with Cecilia Gore, longtime executive director of the Brewers Community Foundation. So, you know, you talked about the folks inside the Brewers who are helping with this particular event today. The foundation was launched with $1 million gift from owner Mark Antanasio and his wife Debbie. And you engage everyone from front office staff, Cecilia, to the coaches and to the players. Can you talk a little bit about the process of how you get them involved, the players in the charitable giving and the efforts you do have at the foundation?
Yeah, we have the pleasure of going down to spring training starting mid-February, and I'm down there for about 2 to 3 weeks. And I, along with Katina Shaw, the Vice President of Community Relations, sit right outside of the clubhouse and in between the dining room. And we meet with every player one-on-one to share what we do in the community, find out what's important to them, and then ask them if they'd be willing to give their time and their talent and their resources. And I'm proud to say we have 100% giving All of our players are excited about being a part of this community. And the thing that I appreciate after being around for a number of years, there's just word of mouth that we have a very generous community and that the community appreciates the players and the families engaging in this way. And so they already know about it. And they're excited to be a part of what we have to offer.
Cecilia, is there a player, maybe past or present, that stands out to you for something incredibly giving and charitable that they've done through the organization?
Well, I think they've all been fantastic. You know, I view this as planting philanthropic seeds with young people that have significant resources. Mm-hmm. And so every gift is appreciated. But I would point to Ryan Braun, who we'll see a little bit more this season, who just consistently over the period of his contract identified four organizations that he wanted to support throughout that time. And he developed a real relationship with each one of those. So not only his time, but financial support. And I thought that was an effective way to give.
Cecilia Gore, the Brewers Community Foundation. Thanks to you and everybody over there, Cecilia, for all you do. Happy baseball.
Thank you. Look forward to seeing you.
And, of course, great way for fans to get involved, the 50-50 raffle at every game. And not for nothing, but there's a few dollars on the line for you, too, if you get in that thing.
Yeah,
that thing gets
attention
up sometimes, yes. Brewers and Mets, 12-10 Thursday to start the season. The home opener at American Family Field next week, Tuesday, against the Twins.
You can do it .com, too. That's the way I do it. .com. I'm .com-ing right now.
Business headlines just ahead with the Milwaukee Business Journal's Sean Ryan.
And this news report. Owatosa design panel next week could give final approvals to Versity Blood Institute's $79 million expansion. That project lets Versity add more scientists and expand its research in blood clotting disorders, cancer, and immune system diseases. Freighter Theta Care Health breaks ground on a new Oshkosh Medical Campus that will open next year. It includes a community hospital, clinics, and a pharmacy. Cafe Benelux in Milwaukee is ready to reopen April 3rd after completing a renovation. New additions include a wraparound, marble-topped bar with taps for Belgian beers that will be the only ones of their kind in Wisconsin. This is Sean Ryan with MilwaukeeBusinessJournal.com on News Radio WTMJ.
And Wisconsin's Morning News sponsored by Kowal Investment Group, the retirement specialist. Retire well with Kowal.
Will you retire worry-free? The financial advisors at Kowal Investment Group can help you get the answer with our streamlined retirement process. Hi, I'm Aaron Kowal of Kowal Investment Group, the retirement specialist. When it comes to planning for retirement, you need to have the confidence that everything and everyone you care about can be taken care of for years to come. Our experienced team is ready to help you create the right retirement plan to help you get there. At Kowal Investment Group, we care about you and your success in retirement. You can trust us to guide you toward a retirement that can support everything that's important to you. You and your needs always come first. That's been the Kowal way for over 30 years. Let us help you find the answers to all of your retirement questions. Call Kowal Investment Group today at 262-522-4040. That's 262-522-4040. Or visit thekowalway.com to schedule your complimentary, no-obligation retirement review.
Kowal Investment Group is a registered investment advisor.
Increase in taxes while families are paying more for everything from gas to groceries is wrong. Milwaukee voters should oppose increase in property taxes by nearly 30% in order to provide increased funding yet again to Milwaukee public schools. They've already wasted nearly $1 billion in new taxpayer funding, and now they want more? They don't even have a plan on how they'll spend it. Enough is enough. Milwaukee voters should just say no.
Paid for by Enough is Enough. Vote no.
Hey, Gene Miller here. The heart of winter is the best time to call my friends at Hometown Windows and Doors. Save heating and cooling dollars down the road with energy-efficient replacement windows and doors from brands like Pella, Anderson, Marvin, and more. Hometown is your local source for wood, vinyl, or fiberglass, plus all of their products are installed by employee carpenters. Stop into their newly remodeled showroom in New Berlin and see the Hometown difference. That's Hometown with an E for your every window and door need, hometownwindows.com.
AdventNorth.com.
stay up to date with your trusted and relevant source in news, sports, traffic, and weather. We are Wisconsin's radio station. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
8:01, I'm Vince Vitrano. This is Wisconsin's Morning News. Wednesday, March 27th, our top story, what Milwaukee can learn for the bridge collapse in Maryland.
I'm Adam Roberts, alleged hate crimes against a women's basketball team.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Now we got some problems. 894, that's going to be backed up out of the Mitchell Interchange all the way to Forest Home through that construction zone. On 94 eastbound, we've got a broken down vehicle at 84th Street on the left shoulder, kind of in a weird spot. And then a little bit further on, right at Hawley Road, the right lane is blocked because of a crash. So obviously we're seeing some big delays through there. Had an earlier accident on Highway 83 right at I-94 off on the right shoulder of northbound 83. And then northbound 43 bagging up all the way around the North Avenue curve up past Keefe. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
High of 41 degrees today under decreasing clouds and a low down to 25 tonight under mostly clear skies. Right now, Milwaukee at 29. And from the WTMJ Breaking News Center, Port of Baltimore at a standstill with the collapsed Key Bridge halting all ships from entering or leaving that port. Governor Maryland Wes Moore telling ABC News this morning the incident is likely to have national supply chain implications.
Those first responders, those law enforcement officials, those people who move quickly, it literally changed the entire dynamic of what that night could have been.
And two people were saved after falling in the water. One is in critical condition.
A Milwaukee professor, meanwhile, says while the Baltimore Bridge collapse was shocking, an incident like it would likely never happen in Milwaukee.
Marquette Assistant Engineer Professor Dr. Andrew Sin tells TMJ4 News bridges are usually built to withstand impacts, but not from a 900-foot cargo ship.
This is not going to happen every day. It shouldn't be a constant concern for people using bridges. There are very few bridges in the world where they could withstand a direct hit from an ocean-faring cargo ship. That's just an incredible amount of load.
He says the more common bridge accidents in Milwaukee would be
maybe truck collisions with lower bridges. So we have seen that a lot, say, in the downtown area of in Milwaukee when we have lots of rail bridges that are pretty low.
Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
Wisconsin has over 14,000 bridges, of which the state has identified over 1,700 in need of repairs.
A child shot late Tuesday night in Milwaukee. Police investigating. It was a non-fatal shooting. 38th and Villard, the 6-year-old, was taken to the hospital, expected to survive. What led up to that shooting, still under investigation. And police are only saying right now they are seeking unknown suspects.
If Waukesha County abandons its status as one of four Wisconsin counties without a half-cent sales tax, it could generate $40 to $50 million in revenue. But not everything would go straight to the county budget. County Executive Paul Farrows on Wisconsin's Afternoon News stating the state statute requires reducing property taxes.
Ours is $1.39 right now per thousand. If we implement a sales tax, a portion of that money would have to go to property tax relief. Then we can look at the other areas and what we would do. That's why I want to put the task force together to really kind of shell out everything of what can happen and how we should go about it.
Farrow creating a task force of 40 municipal, business, and nonprofit leaders to study options like the sales tax to generate more revenue.
Trouble off the court for a top women's college basketball team. Steve Kaifen from CBS News has that.
University of Utah women's basketball coach Lynn Roberts says her team experienced a series of what she calls racist hate crimes at the hotel where they were staying in Idaho for the women's March Madness tournament.
Racism is real. And it happens.
She says some outside the hotel restaurant used the N-word and had a Confederate flag. Coeur d'Alene Mayor Jim Hammond.
We express regret and true sorrow that your student athletes were treated with such disdainful treatment while visiting our city.
The team switched hotels and now police are investigating. Steve Kaifen, CBS News.
Coming up, too much sweet and too much salt.
Signing Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 8:05.
The sooner you address your joint pain, the better. You really don't want your pain to become chronic, to a point when surgery may become your only option. Address your joint pain issues early and calm down that inflammation and increase your mobility. Get the joints moving again and the blood circulating. That can be very beneficial. Plus, why not just feel better sooner? By coming to Rejuvenix, at the very least, we can alleviate your pain so you can feel and move better to help you live a better quality of life. Don't you deserve at least that? Multi-joint treatments at Rejuvenix can cost as little as, well, nothing. That's because we are in network with almost all major insurance plans, including Medicare and Medicaid. So you really have nothing to lose, except a very good chance of living with a lot less pain. This is Richard Salinas, registered nurse with Rejuvenex Arthritis Clinics, where we can alleviate your pain and rejuvenate your life. Go to Rejuvenex.com to request your appointment.
Easter is this Sunday. Take your family to the amazing Mineshaft restaurant in Hartford for the all-you-can-eat Good Friday fish fry for under $10. The Easter brunch is also all-you-can-eat. Kids under 3 eat free. Reserve now, MineshaftRestaurant.com.
Signing Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 8:06.
It's been nearly 12 years since six people were killed at the Wisconsin Sikh temple shooting in Oak Creek. Pardeep Kalika's father was among them. He has since been active in the Sikh community, and beyond working on ways to heal, he's worked on helping create the documentary Waking in Oak Creek. Kalika telling Wisconsin's Midday News his latest mission is around community mental health.
Non-practitioners, not people within the mental health field, so that society can understand that they can help their loved ones. So if you're at a corporation, you can help your employees, or if you're in a school setting, educational setting, that you can help your students, their parents.
Lake is making that happen as the Behavior Health Responder Director at Carroll University. It's a program for people like first responders and caretakers.
Do you know your Splenda from your Stevia? Non-nutritive sweeteners have become just as commonplace as artificial substitutes for cane sugar, but new studies are showing even these plant-derived sugar substitutes can have major health implications. President and CEO of the Medical College of Wisconsin, Dr. John Raymond, speaking about it on Wisconsin's Afternoon News.
Beverages that contain non-nutritive sweeteners increase the risk of atrial fibrillation by 20%. Sweeteners with natural sweeteners increase the risk by 10%. And to put it into perspective, that 20% risk with non-nutritive sweeteners was with just one can of soda per day.
Dr. Raymond adds non-nutritive sweeteners often increase sugar cravings, leading to weight gain, which is, like you've said, Vince, which we were kind of trying to avoid here.
Yeah, and how about too much salt in the diet? CBS correspondent Michael George reports on the impact of too much salt.
Americans from low-income backgrounds are eating too much salt, and it's leading to serious health problems. That's the findings of a study published in JAMA Network Open. It shows nearly 80% of black and white low-income Americans are consuming sodium levels above the recommended daily amount, which is linked to cardiovascular disease deaths.
The recommended sodium intake, 2,300 milligrams or less per day. What's that mean? It's equal to about a teaspoon of table salt.
In no universe is anyone in this nation having one teaspoon of table salt.
8:09 on Wisconsin's Morning News.
America is kept safe because the Army National Guard responds, protects, and supports our nation when it needs them most. The Army National Guard responds to disasters such as wildfires and floods. They protect us with missile defense, cybersecurity, and civilian support teams for chemical, biological, and radiological hazards. Be there for your community and your country. Visit NationalGuard.com to learn more about part-time service. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Aired by the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association and this station.
Get your rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval to buy at accunet.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercier here. When it comes to painting, don't do it yourself. Call the pros at your local neighborhood Serta Pro Painters. That's what we did. Serta Pro came out, gave us choices, walked us through the process, and then when they were there, it was quick, it was easy. Our home is beautiful. Excellent workmanship all the way around. It's Serta Pro Painters. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated right here in Wisconsin. Schedule your free estimate online at SertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry. Semperfy.
SemperfyRoofing.com.
Eager to remodel your kitchen, bath, or rec room? This is Rob Adair, and we're ready with a personal redesign for you. Adair Floors and Remodeling in Franklin. Give us a call and get personal care from Adair. 761-3660. AdairFloors.com.
810, what do you see on the roads, Deb?
Well, we got some problems in Waukesha County. Some debris in the roadway on 94 westbound, right about at Highway 164. There's a couple of squads out there. They definitely have the center lane blocked, but they are picking up some debris around the area. I'm not quite sure what it is. It looks like it was some metal pieces, and they're trying to run them off to the side of the road. So occasionally the right lane will get blocked as the officer moves the stuff off to the side. But Hopefully that'll be gone sooner rather than later. We do have another problem, though, on eastbound 94 at Holly Road. Right lane remains closed right now because of a crash. That's got things backed up all the way back to 92nd Street. And we've also got some delays along northbound 4394, broken down vehicle at Beecher off to the side, and westbound 894, slow out of the Mitchell to Forest Home. BRI's on the roads report accidents, slowdowns, and road conditions to the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen traffic tip line at 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
High of 41 degrees today under decreasing clouds and mostly clear tonight. Chilly, low down to 25. Milwaukee temp at 30 degrees.
Live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios, this is Wisconsin's Morning News. Here's your host, Vince Petrano.
Glad you're with us on Wisconsin's Morning News this Wednesday morning. And we thought we were done talking about stadium lease deals.
The ride never ends,
Vince. That is not the case, apparently, this morning. Milwaukee Brewers home opener now less than a week away. And when the crew takes the field coming up on Tuesday, they will do so knowing that American Family Field will be their home for a generation more. All the back and forth about the Brewers signing that long-term lease with the Stadium District, who's chipping in for what, on maintenance, upkeep, improvements to the ballpark through 2050, all worked out, said, and done now. Green Bay Packers' turn. They are looking to the future, and apparently talks on a long-term lease extension for Lambeau Field with the city of Green Bay have stalled. And the Packers are talking about this publicly. Adam's got some clips of Packers president Mark Murphy addressing the issue, and I've got a statement from the mayor's office as well. But let me set you up with a little bit of information about what's happening here. The Packers opened what is now Lambeau Field. It was originally called City Stadium, as the city is still part owner of said stadium. So the Packers don't own Lambeau Field outright. There is also a stadium district in Green Bay, sort of like what we have in Milwaukee, as taxpayers in Brown County largely funded, if you remember, 24, 25 years ago, the just short of $300 million renovation with a sales tax that was Brown County only. And quick aside to that, I lived in Green Bay for years. That was my first job in TV. I went to college up there. The Packers, as a team on the field, obviously very popular.
I don't think that's up for debate.
Okay, right. But folks who aren't from around there, if you don't have friends or family up there, my brother still lives up there. The Packers, as an entity, as an organization, a little bit different deal. When they were trying to get this referendum passed in Green Bay, I remember for a story working with the news, walking door to door in neighborhoods in Brown County when then Packers president Bob Harlan was knocking on people's doors like politicians do, trying to garner support for the tax referendum to what they thought was save Lambeau Field. Remember, Lambeau Field used to be that green sort of sheet metal.
Oh, yeah. I do actually remember.
It was not much of a looker. So now you have this beautiful, historic-looking stadium and all of that, and that was because of the sales tax that eventually passed. It went to referendum, and if you're just a casual fan, you don't know Green Bay politics, you would have thought, okay, they put some to a referendum for the Packers in Green Bay, in Brown County, passed 99-1, or at least 80-20. The vote margin was only 6 points that passed back in the day. So people in that community, they are far more shrewd negotiators than one might expect when it comes to the team. Here we are today. This lease that the Packers have, apparently up in 9 years. There are some options for the team to extend the lease on the current terms that have been agreed to, but basically, the lease expires in 9 years. So it sounds like we have time, but there are things that enter into that equation. Apparently, the Packers have been negotiating with the city for some time. And President Mark Murphy says they have been informed by the city that they are done talking for now. Eric Gingrich is the mayor there, so we'll hear from him in a moment in a statement. What is Mark Murphy saying about this?
So Murphy was reported by a number of the press, the beat writers, if you will, talking about a litany of topics yesterday, and this came up. Murphy expressing, at least for now, his disappointment.
I guess I'd say that for us, the keys are, you know, we've invested a lot of money in the stadium. We're not asking for any public money. I think going forward, we're willing to put in $1.5 billion into the stadium.
Now, I want to stick on that point that Murphy mentioned. We're not asking for public money. Anyone who's been in the world of stadium repairs, renovations, threats to move a team, et cetera, that always comes up. How much money is the public going to be asked to invest in a project? And Murphy's saying here We have not asked for that. As this progresses, and you mentioned, Vince, we're 9 years out from when the lease is up, so this is by no means, it has to happen now. But as this story progresses, that's going to be important to watch that verbiage. Does that change? Does that get amended? Like, well, I said no public money, but now inflation or this or that and the other thing, and now we have to pivot into this, in, if you will.
And well, there's also an important reason that this is on the table right now. What the Packers have said is apparently they want to do some things ahead of the 2025 draft.
I believe it's when
we have the draft in Green Bay, and they want to put some more money into the stadium and the infrastructure around it, and they're considering holding off on that until these talks at least resume.
Right, Murphy addressing that as well.
Given the status of negotiations, we're going to halt those investments. So that's going to affect our fans and also affect us for the draft.
So that is the more, I think, immediacy of this, is that we have a very massive event that we've been fighting and pushing for God knows how long. Well, now these $80 million in investments that we're going to help supplement that, we're putting a pause on that. That's our bargaining chip right now.
Which, the Packers were paying for. You heard Murphy say they've put $1 billion into the stadium. They're planning another $1.5 billion over the life of what would the next lease be. What's the mayor saying about this? Eric Genrich is the mayor in Green Bay. He released a statement to my old colleagues up there at WFRV-TV, Channel 5, Eyewitness News. And I'll read that in part from the mayor in Green Bay. The city met in good faith with the Packers over the course of several months to discuss reopening the lease terms based on the team's request. Although there were productive conversations and the Packers expressed openness to the city's proposed terms, the written proposal did not reflect those discussions. Common Council and I are united in our assessment of the terms offered by the Packers, and if the team wants a different answer, they need to bring forward a proposal that's worthy of our consideration and keeping with what was expressed during our conversations. Super wonky to get into the terms, and there will be a time for that, I guess, as we get closer. Who's asking for what and that? But right now, what you have in the most basic of terms is the city's asking for things that the Packers don't want to provide, or vice versa, depending on how you look at it. The city says, all right, till we come closer to where we were talking about, we're not interested in talking anymore. That's the end of that. So in any negotiation, you look at who holds the cards, right? Who has the leverage to get more of what they want? In a good negotiation, I guess, you get a little bit of what you want. Your opponent or the person with whom you're negotiating gets a little bit of what they want.
Now, another important wrinkle in all of this to consider as well is that Mark Murphy is the one kind of leading the conversation from the team side, but he's not going to be president and CEO by the time that this stadium lease would need to be renewed. He has to be out. That's per team bylaws, and that's coming up, I believe, coming up. Is it this July or next? It's one of the next two Julys, but certainly during this whole stretch of when they're going to be negotiating this. So reasonably, the board will put someone new into that position who may have a very different take on all of this.
And in terms of who has the leverage, okay, let's take the Packers side. What leverage does the city of Green Bay have? Like, what is Green Bay without the Packers? And I can tell you, having lived up there, folks are very sensitive to that question. Green Bay has a lot of wonderful things to do. It's a great place to work. As I said, my brother is still up there. He raises his family there. It's a wonderful community outside of what happens for 8 or so Sundays every year at 1265 Lombardi Avenue. So, you know, there are a lot of great things that Green Bay has going for it. But certainly if you're the Packers, you're like, look, we have the Titletown District. We have Lambeau Field. We are a year-round global destination for fans of the game. They come to our restaurant. They come to our museum, to the Hall of Fame, all of these things. Look at the economic impact. It's north of $10 million every time they have a game, extra events. What are you going to do without us, Green Bay?
You have this giant 80,000-seat thing that we've worked together to build. We leave. I mean, what are you going to do with that thing? Is it just going to become an eyesore? Are you going to hold weddings in it half of the year?
So that's what's interesting is in terms of the counter leverage then, if you're Green Bay, what do you mean leave? The Green Bay Packers are a publicly held team. They're a nonprofit incorporation.
Very unique in sports.
So they don't have a rich owner that can just say, look, St. Louis, they don't have a football team anymore. They'd sure like to get the NFL back there. Or, you know, what about San Diego? They lost a team. They'd love to get the NFL. Oklahoma City sure would love to have some NFL football. They can't just pick up and leave because you don't have an owner that can make that decision. Well, couldn't they sell the team? Okay, but Who would get rich off of that? There is no owner. It's a non-profit, and there's that old story about how if the team were ever sold, all the money would go to the VFW post up there, the Legion. I believe that actually was in the original charter, but is now no longer the case as there's a foundation.
Correct.
So the money would go to this foundation. But again, Mark Murphy can't get rich on selling the team. The board of directors can't get rich on selling the team. They're all a bunch of locals up there. They're local people and business leaders who are on that board. So there's no advantage to them to selling the team. So that, in terms of leverage for the Packers, it's like, what are you threatening to do if you don't get your way? So both sides of this definitely have some leverage. It'd be interesting to watch how they use that.
And also important to remember, again, that this is very early. Like, we are 9 years out from when this would expire. Now, to be fair, the Brewers were also quite a bit separated from when their lease was set to expire anyway. But there was that sense of urgency. We were living it every single day. So it will be interesting to see if this picks up in intensity. And as we get closer to the draft as well, if the city's starting to see things and realize, oh, maybe we could use that extra improvement to this before all these people are coming here.
You hope everybody gets to the table, because what's good for Green Bay is good for the Packers and vice versa. And this should be a deal where each side says, okay, what do you need for us to move forward here in this one-of-a-kind partnership between community and professional sports operation here in the Green Bay Packers? But putting that on your radar here, it's not panic button time at all, but for somebody, I wonder who started this first, who whispered in whose ear first about this is happening, who thought it was to their advantage to start talking about this publicly. But that's how both sides set up at this point, and the draft coming to Green Bay in 2025. 8:22 on Wisconsin's Morning News. Tax tips just ahead. They're brought to you by the Neal Group. For less stress with the IRS, visit nealgroup.net. That's NEALgroup.net for a free consultation.
Hi, this is John Neal, CPA and founder of the Neal Group, with a tip from Tucker the Tax Dog. Tax tip number one, make sure you report all your income when you're filing your return. By law, you need to report all income you receive, even if you don't get a W-2 or 1099. Look at last year's return to see if anything changed. Don't be in a rush to file. You don't want to get a letter from the IRS because you forgot to report a stock sale and they say you owe $10,000. In reality, you may have sold that stock at a loss and will get a refund by amending your return. Why raise your blood pressure and have the headache of correcting your return? Do it right the first time. For more information on this tip and other tax tips, go to nealgroup.net or stop in and see us. You can give Tucker a belly rub and a milk bone.
WTMJ's John Mercier here. Join me as we count down to the RNC in Milwaukee. We'll talk to the biggest names across the political landscape.
James Wigerson, a strong political writer, one of the best I've ever seen.
I think the election will look a lot more like 2020 than it did in 2016.
Full podcast available on WTMJ.com or text RNC to the Old National Bank Talk and Text Line, 855-616-1620, and get a link sent directly to you. It's the countdown to the RNC podcast, only here on WTMJ.
I am hardly suggesting we're done with winter, but it is a good time already to book your spring air conditioner checkup with Absolute Comfort HVAC and Electrical. YourComfortGuys.com. Nicole and Brent, they're the owners of the company. They're wonderful people, and they built their company on relationships. You get to know them before you need them in an emergency. So you get Brent or maybe his son Drew, they come out to the house, they service your air conditioner, get that thing all tuned up and ready to go in the spring. I bought the full package, so for me that included the fall furnace tune-up as well. Now I know I'm set with the heating and cooling for the year. Call Absolute Comfort HVAC and Electrical to get on the schedule now. Family business that will treat your home like theirs. Absolute Comfort HVAC and Electrical. The number is 262-664-9284. Your Comfort Guys. That's yourcomfortguys.com.
Wait now or wait a little longer. You may have just increased your lifetime income by tens of thousands of dollars. That's how Social Security can work for you. The longer you wait, the more money you may get. Deciding when to start taking your Social Security benefits is one of the most important retirement decisions you'll make. Our team at Drake & Associates can show you the options and help make the right decision for your situation. You spent decades paying in. Optimize what comes out. Drake & Associates can help you squeeze every penny out of your Social Security benefits. Claim your free retirement ready toolkit that has guides on Social Security. To get our complimentary toolkit, call or text SS to 414-409-9982. That's calling or texting SS to 414-409-9982.
Investment advisory services provided by Drake & Associates, LLC, an SEC registered investment advisor. Insurance products are offered through a separate company, Loft Financial Advisory Group, LLC, a Wisconsin insurance agency. Clients are under no obligation to purchase any recommended insurance products.
Whether you're seeking endless sunshine, ancient landmarks, or scenic views, Fox World Travel can take you there. We are proud to partner with outstanding cruise companies, including Holland America, Princess Cruises, Celebrity, and Royal Caribbean, to bring you unbeatable rates for your next cruise. Unleash your inner adventurer and book your dream cruise by visiting foxworldtravel.com or calling us at 866-GO-FOX-GO. Enjoy the freedom of unpacking once and set sail for adventure.
Adrian was seriously injured when a careless driver merged into her lane.
Gruber was there for everything that I needed. Any questions that I had, Gruber was there. They made me feel like everything about my situation and my accident was very important to them, and that made me feel good. And I would definitely call Gruber again for that.
Serving Wisconsin for over 35 years, Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
They go above and beyond for their clients.
Traffic is sponsored by the all-new Burkhart Sporting Goods.
The all-new Burkhart Sporting Goods, the Midwest's best baseball and softball training facility and retail center in New Berlin and Fox Point.
Checking in with Debbie here, coming up on the bottom of the hour.
All right, westbound on 94, we've got backups out of the Marquette interchange all the way to Hawley Road. The eastbound side has an accident at Hawley Road, still blocking that right lane, so it's solid pretty much from 92nd Street to that point. Keep that in mind. Other than that, we've got northbound 43 a little bit backed up between Locust and Keith. Westbound 894, slow from 27th Street to about 68th Street. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
A28 Wisconsin's Morning News. March is Multiple Sclerosis Awareness Month, and maybe if it hadn't been that, I might not have spent a whole lot of time making myself aware of what it is. It's, you know, that's why they have these awareness days and awareness months, and been one of those conditions, I admit, I don't know much about nor understand. No one in my family or immediate friend circle has been touched by this, but it's a local story that caught my attention, and I share it with you. This woman, originally from Greendale, where our family lives now, she connected with me. Brittany Heinz-Walters is going to run across the state of Wisconsin this summer, so the width of the state, and she's going to do it in just 6 days. This is an effort to raise money for MS research, prevention, treatment, one day a cure, and she has multiple reasons for taking part.
It's a cross-country relay run. It covers 3,260 miles total. It starts in Santa Monica, California, and it ends in New York.
If I'm correct here, you're going to run essentially a marathon a day for a number of days straight?
Yes, exactly. So, well,
how are you going to do that?
I don't know. We'll see. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. But I haven't done anything like this before, so I'm really excited. But I've been training now. Total training will be about 10 months.
She's committed to raising at least $10,000 in the effort to better understand MS.
Multiple sclerosis, or MS, a potentially debilitating movement disorder, and affects over 2.2 million people worldwide. And it's an autoimmune disease, which is characterized by damage to neurons in the central nervous system.
And those neurons are pretty important.
Since neurons are necessary for most human functions, how we think, feel, move, MS can lead to a range of symptoms. They're often unpredictable, things like movement slowing, weakness, pain, balance impairments, cognitive changes, depression.
A lot of information, and Brittany should know, she's a PhD in kinesiology, an assistant professor of neuromechanics and motor control at Seattle University. This is what she does. And what are the chances her roommate from college was recently diagnosed with MS?
So my dear friend Lisa, she was diagnosed with MS a few years ago, and just her resilience and determination as she faced the challenges of her diagnosis. And then she also ran the same segment that I'll be running after her diagnosis. So she's really served as as an inspiration for me to become involved with this organization and apply to do the run.
An inspiration to run from Platteville to Milwaukee, where fittingly the finish line party will be at a brewery.
Starting at 11 a.m. at City Lights Brewery in Milwaukee, so funds raised there will also go to the organization's mission.
Man, how glad are you going to be to have a beer?
Very glad. I'm glad that it ends at a brewery. I'm all for it.
Every stride, one step closer to a cure for MS. Vince Vetrano, WTMJ News. Brittany's Leg of the Run comes up in early July. The MS Run, the U.S. Relay, over the years has generated some $3 million. And you have to be chosen to run. So tribute to Brittany for being selected, for putting herself out there, being committed to the cause. You want to learn more about her efforts, the relay? You want to visit that after party when she makes it to Milwaukee or just want to help? She's a little more than halfway to her fundraising goal of about $10,000. You can text the word RUN, R-U-N, to 855-616-1620. And I'll send you a link to the story that's up on our website, which includes a link to her fundraising page. 8:31 on Wisconsin's Morning News.
Okay, I'm ready to record my jewelry store's new radio spot. We got a great script that really goes after Diamonds Direct and how they're nothing special. And how we can match their price. Great stuff.
Great. And we have this new technology that bleeps out any false claims, so it saves us time with editing. So you can start anytime.
Okay, here it goes. When you visit our jewelry store, we'll absolutely guarantee direct. Our diamonds come straight from the mine. We have cutters and hey, what the.
The hard truth is that other jewelry stores simply can't do what Diamonds Direct can. Diamonds Direct has special relationships with De Beers, international connections, and virtually unlimited buying power. The result is true direct importer pricing, exceptional quality, and up to 30 times the diamond selection you find at other stores.
I can't believe this thing won't let me say
Diamonds Direct, your love, our passion. Get more truth at DiamondsDirect.com.
Make it a real Mad March with a playoff payout at Pottawatomie. Every week, you could score your share of 100 grand in cash and free play. Play this March for drawing entries. Win each Thursday. Plus, the prizes refresh every week for even more winners. The playoff payout at Pottawatomie, Milwaukee. It's anyone's game. For more details, visit paysbig.com/payout. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you the spring supplies and equipment you need because we get you. For farms and projects of any size, find the right products at the right prices. Like $10 off select 50-pound bags of AgriMaster Supreme All-Milk Calf Milk Replacer. 5 gallons of Mystic Diesel Oil, only $50.99 after sale and rebate. Select Ratchet Load Binders, buy one, get one free. And assorted DZ Truck Bed Mats, $20 off. We get you what you need because we get you. At Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
If you have breathing triangle issues, like compromised nasal breathing, and sleep, snoring, or even sleep apnea issues, a call to Advent makes sense. Because breathing well will help you live better.
AdventKnows.com.
Traffic is sponsored by the famous Fox and Hounds restaurant near Holly Hill.
Buy one dinner, get one free tonight at the historic Fox and Hounds Supper Club, including steak and lobster. And desserts are buy one, get one free. Tables are open, FoxandHoundsRestaurant.com.
Breaking news as it happens. Stay up to date with your trusted and relevant source in news, sports, traffic, and weather. We are Wisconsin's radio station. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
At 8:34, I'm Vince Vetrano. Our top story on Wisconsin's Morning News, abuse allegations against a Milwaukee Public Schools principal.
I'm Adam Roberts. The path ahead for the site of the former Northridge Mall.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Eastbound 94 still has that right lane blocked at Hawley Road with a crash. That's backing things up all the way to 92nd Street. Westbound side's going to be slow from about 25th Street all the way through the Mitchell Boulevard area. And then we've also got an issue on northbound 43 right at Michigan Street. Broken down vehicle off on the side. And Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Storm Team forecast calls for a high of 41 degrees today and mostly clear skies tonight with a low down to 25. Right now, 29 in Milwaukee. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, a federal lawsuit accuses a Milwaukee Public Schools principal of abusing a first grader. saying the principal abused that first grader because the child had gay parents. Former assistant principal at Milwaukee French Immersion School, Kasango Kalamula, allegedly told students that his parents would, quote, burn in hell. And at one point, he threatened to kill the student if that student told anyone about the abuse. The student, referred to in the lawsuit, is now in psychiatric treatment for trauma and anxiety. Despite the allegations, Kalambula was promoted to acting principal of French Immersion and later left to become principal of Mary McLeod Bethune Academy, where he still works to this day.
Waukesha County considering a half-cent sales tax to keep funding big-ticket budget items like its sheriff's department. County Executive Paul Farrell tells Wisconsin's Afternoon News the consideration is not in response to Milwaukee County's sales tax increase.
We're in a different position. Waukesha County, third largest county, we have the lowest spending of any county in the state per person. So I think we're very fiscally prudent, but we still have high level of services. We've been able to balance that out. The challenges come in. We're capped by how much property levy we can have.
Farrell says Ozaukee County, the only county in Wisconsin with a lower tax rate than Waukesha.
After years of waiting, demolition on the former Northridge Mall finally began.
TMJ4 News' Sydney Yor speaks to residents in the area about what they think the mall can be in the future. Jonathan Swiam says,
I would hope that one day it becomes something like a recreational center. Maybe do something to it where again family can come and shop and have fun.
Harold Turner says,
I think we can bring our city back to the original place that we was comfortable living. We had restaurants around and people was coming from all over to shop and do great things here in Milwaukee. Milwaukee's a great city.
Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
Demolition expected to last until fall of 25, and then decisions will be made on what to put there.
Time for news about your money. The WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update at the opening bell. All green for the majors to start the day. The Dow's up 293 points to 39,575, while the S&P 500 up 28 to 5,231, and the NASDAQ up 47 points this morning to 16,362. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite. Financial planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here. Guthrie and Fry protects the water in my house. Guthrie and Fry has provided expert advice, quality service, and reliable water since 1974. Owners Sue and Rob are well-known and very generous in the local community for supporting great causes that change lives. We've got their water softener. We've got their reverse osmosis system. Our water is crisp, clean, and clear. GFwater.com. It's Guthrie and Fry.
Better water makes a big difference. Guthrie and Fry.
Just a few days ago, we had that heavy, wet snow, and folks, yeah, although a lot of it melted off, you still had to get out there and shovel. You feel something snap on you, hear the dreaded pop, maybe worse, a fall. Vince Vetrano for Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. If something's still bothering you, time to get that checked out and look about getting it fixed with the experts in orthopedic care. That's OAW. You can book an appointment anytime, but if you need relief now, you don't have to spend hours waiting in line at the emergency room, paying those big hospital prices. Ortho ASAP clinics have hours Monday through Saturday in Pewaukee, Monday through Friday in Brookfield. You just walk right in. You look at sprains, strains, dislocations, maybe even a fracture. X-rays available right there on site. It's faster, it's easier, likely less expensive than a trip to the ER or urgent care. And now you're in the good hands of the folks at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Walk right in at the Ortho ASAP clinics or make an appointment online at orthowisconsin.com.
Shop Steinhoffels and get a Tempur-Pedic queen mattress for only $52 per month with their 60-month financing, plus $300 in Steinhoffels cash. Upgrade to the Tempur-Breeze and sleep up to 10 degrees cooler for just $96 per month, only at Steinhoffels.
Why are people saying "Hugh yeah" to Jackson Hewitt? Find out before it's too late. Hurry into Jackson Hewitt today.
Here's another remarkable success story from QC Kinetics. This one from Chad, who hurt his knee at the gym one day, and it just kept on hurting for months.
From my high school football and wrestling days, I already had a little bit of damage in there, but this just sent it over the edge.
Chad tried traditional treatments with no improvement when he turned to the non-surgical regenerative treatments at QC Kinetics.
It was really fascinating how they did their work, and the science behind it was very intriguing, and it works. Extracting the cure out of my own body body blew my mind. It's like I'm brand new again. It was fantastic.
That's because the QC Kinetics natural biologic treatments use your body's own healing power to restore damaged tissue in your hips, shoulders, back, and knees, providing long-lasting relief.
Now I'm back at the gym. I'm 100%, feeling great.
If you're tired of suffering with pain from arthritis or injury, call QC Kinetics now for a free consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
Minutes before 9 o'clock on Wisconsin's Morning News.
So, Vince, we've got a possible game changer for parents on the go, choosing to or relying on, in some cases, for rideshare services, depending on where you live and your situation. CBS News correspondent Jim Krasula on this one.
Uber is teaming up with the car seat company Nuna to provide Nuna's convertible Rava car seats for young families in need of transportation in New York City and Los Angeles. The seats will be available for children between 5 and 65 pounds in the two cities, but only one child per ride.
And Uber offering a discount for two Uber car seat rides in the cities between now and April 21st. Obviously, not being rolled out in any area near us at this point, but I can certainly see if you're a parent trying to decide.
For sure.
I would certainly take that up.
No Uber doubt. Nuna. Uber Nuna.
Say it four more times.
841 on Wisconsin's Morning News.
Skilled trade workers are the backbone of every community and also the Army National Guard. Soldiers trained to keep the power flowing, engines running, and in every other trade needed to accomplish the mission. These soldiers are on the fast track to learning skills that can set them up for success at home with companies looking to hire the best. Their resumes are being built through their paid training and part-time service. Find out how you too can learn a trade profession by visiting NationalGuard.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Aired by the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association and this station.
I'm Jim Tolkien, president of the Auto Dealers Association of Metro Milwaukee. There are so many reasons to service your car or truck and buy your next vehicle at one of the 115 ATOM member dealers. ATOM dealers employ more than 7,500 people in southeastern Wisconsin, which helps support thousands of local families. ATOM also contributes to many local charities. For example, ATOM recently completed their Change Your Oil, Change Lives promotion, benefiting Feeding America Eastern Wisconsin. Over the past 14 years, they've raised over $875,000, which provided more than 2.6 million meals to people in southeast Wisconsin, the majority being children and seniors. These are just a few reasons to service your car or truck and buy your next vehicle from an ATOM member dealer instead of a national online company with no ties to our community. To find an ATOM member dealer, visit ATOM.com. That's ADAMM.com.
At 8:43 this morning, the search for six construction workers at the site of that catastrophic bridge collapse in Baltimore suspended. What caused that massive container ship to slam into the bridge support, bringing that span down, beginning to come a bit clearer this morning. ABC News correspondent Derek Dennis is on it live with us this morning. Derek, what new have we learned sort of in the last 24 hours over how this came to be?
Well, we got a lot of detail on the preliminary cause. The container ship that hit the support column to the bridge, causing the collapse, lost propulsion, lost power and steering, allowing it to slam into that support column, causing the collapse. So we learned that detail. We also learned the NTSB, which is the lead investigative agency on the scene, has recovered the ship's data recorders. That'll be very telling into piecing together the timeline of what happened and how it happened. And then we also learned that the ship's captain and crew were able to put out a mayday call to the bridge command and other authorities, getting them to stop the bridge traffic across the span, get the other ships that may have been trying to get into the area away. That undoubtedly saved lives. But this morning, there is still a grim search for six workers who are on the span doing pothole repairs. They're believed to have perished in the fall of this bridge. They're not expected to have survived all these hours later.
Derek, are we hearing any more about the status of the port as well? I know it seems like a secondary issue, but it is a very major port on the East Coast.
It's a big port and a major source of concern, not just nationally, but internationally. Authorities have to come up with a plan of how to reopen operations to get shipping moving again in and out of the port of Baltimore. Some $80 billion in commerce a year goes through that port. So it being shut down for any length of time is a concern. But so far, no definitive word on how it'll be reopened, because the shipping channel is essentially shut off because it's got all the bridge debris. The container ship is still there. Bodies in the water, vehicles in the water, all of that is preventing shipping operations from continuing in and out of the Port of Baltimore. So it's a big concern. Authorities say they're on top of it, but they've got to come up with a plan. We hope to hear more today.
ABC's Derek Dennis with us live this morning. Derek, appreciate your time. I know you got a lot of stations to talk to this morning, so thanks for being with us. So, you know, more on, to expand on what he was saying, first let's go to that latter point, right, how much this can have ripple effects throughout the country, both via water and via land, because obviously, right, the port is shut down, but then also this is a huge trucking thoroughfare, and apparently I've been reading a little bit about the traffic patterns there in Baltimore. Like, this was the way, this is 695, so you got Interstate 95, which runs more through Baltimore, but this is sort of the way around, like we have 894 versus 94 in Milwaukee, and so this was where all the truck traffic went. And you've got an interstate system that starts at the Canadian border, does I-95, goes all the way to Miami. So you have that interruption, and then obviously ships into and out of that port to get to the interior of that country, of our country.
Recall when that ship was stuck in the Suez Canal a few years ago and the ripple effects that that had on the immediate area, but of course the international economy. And specifically with the Baltimore port, lots of automobiles that come in from other areas, you think European vehicles, they get sent and imported through this port. And so ripple effect, could we see potentially the cost of new vehicles go up a little bit? It's probably too early to tell for sure, but it's something to monitor.
No, but right, when we have a global economy, everything is connected, right? So everything is connected to something else. On the earlier point that Derek made about how the ship was able to communicate that they were having trouble early on, think of how many lives were saved by at least their ability to communicate that out and to shut down some of the traffic that would have been going over that bridge. Fortunately, again, it occurred overnight, with like 1:30 in the morning.
Correct.
Local time there, so you didn't have a lot of traffic to begin with, but they were able to shut that thing down so more and more cars and other vehicles didn't end up on that bridge when it collapsed. Quick thinking there, and at least authorities were able to spring into action.
Right, and a lot of very heavy presence already, because as this is such a major port, you've got a lot of Coast Guard authorities on scene. It's not like this was in an isolated area where there would have been little to no time and maybe only one person on scene. Very heavily fortified, but to your point, you're only having maybe a minute or two from that mayday call. You see that ship coming to the column, and you got to act in that moment, and thankfully they did.
Next part of the investigation, too, is whose fault is it? What caused the ship to lose propulsion? I've been reading some theories that I don't want to put out there because I haven't had a chance, to be honest with you, to investigate, you know, the legitimacy of the theories. But there are a couple of them floating out there. And so that those questions still need to be answered. What caused the ship to lose its propulsion? Why did this happen? Whose fault is it? And that will all come in the coming days and weeks ahead. 8:48 on Wisconsin's Morning News. Debbie, one more time here before 9 o'clock.
All right, 94 eastbound still has that right lane block because of that crash that happened right about at Hawley Road. Backups coming in from just before 84th Street. The westbound side is going to be a bit heavy as you're making your way from about 25th Street all the way to Hawley Road. The rest of the system, not bad except for 894 westbound, of course, through that construction zone. So you're seeing delays from about 20th Street all the way past 68th Street. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Fleet Farm's got everything you need for everyday life. Brands from Carhartt to Milwaukee to Purina to Goodyear to Rapala to Levi's and a whole lot more. In-store or online, check out all the brands Fleet Farm carries to help make your everyday life better.
Hey, this is WTMJ's Steve Scafidi. I talk a lot about politics, but sometimes I just want to sit back and have a nice conversation about, well, whatever I want to. This week on the Scafidiology Podcast, regular contributor Martin Moore on the TikTok question.
The parents invented all this stuff, and the parents are using this stuff right in front of their kids. So I'm surprised adults are surprised that kids use this stuff as much as they do, because this is all they know.
You can listen to this conversation or any of my Scafidiology conversations wherever you get your podcast or at WTMJ.com.
Vince Vitrano here for Connect Chiropractic. Going to see the crew today. I love talking with my fellow patients when I'm there and hearing their stories of healing and better health. For as many people that go to see Dr. Alex Young and his team, we all got a story. I was talking with Missy a while back. She had a bunch of stuff bothering her. She told me friends even said she walked with a slight limp that she hadn't so much noticed, but they did. And they don't say that anymore. Missy feeling so much better. Tom came up to me at the doc's office the other day, introduced himself, said he'd been going elsewhere for care, wasn't happy with the results, heard us talking about Connect Chiropractic, and he's very happy that he is in the care of their kind and effective doctors. No twisting, no cracking, no popping, gentle, pain-free, effective treatment. You can join the docs at Connect Chiropractic in Wauwatosa for an open house next month. That's coming up April 24th at the office there. Sign up coming soon to the website. They also have a location in Delafield now. If you want to be seen right away, no reason to wait. It's Go Connect Chiro. That's GoConnectChiro.com.
Hi, this is John Neal, CPA, best-selling author, and founder of the Neal Group. I have some questions for you. Who does your books? Hopefully not you. There are better things for you to do in running your business. Do you trust the numbers? Good numbers are critical for making good decisions. Are you getting the advice you need to minimize your taxes and put more money in your pocket? A good advisor makes suggestions to help your business grow and minimize taxes, not just put numbers on a form. Do your calls get returned and your questions answered? Many of our new clients tell us they love our quick response time. We have helped countless businesses increase their profits and lower stress. Get the advice you want and need to grow your business and minimize taxes. If you want to get started on the road to making more money and having less stress, visit nealgroup.net right now. That's NEALgroup.net. The first meeting is free to see if we can help. Again, NEALgroup.net.
CertaPro Painters know how important your home is to you. I know how good a job they do because CertaPro Painters did our house. WTMJ's John Mercier here. It was professional, it was easy, it was quick, and it was efficient. And so affordable. It's CertaPro Painters. They get the job done right, even those hard-to-reach places they will knock out of the ballpark. Free estimates, reliable communication, professional painting, all at the right price. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters. Choose the team we went with, CertaPro Painters.
Listen to the Fix-It Show this Saturday morning in the 7 o'clock hour with special guest Chris Mancuso from Accurate Basement Repair. Chris will discuss and answer questions about basement problems and solutions. Accurate Basement Repair serves all of southeastern Wisconsin with comprehensive, cost-effective basement repairs, including foundation restoration and waterproofing. Check them out online at AccurateBasementRepair.com and listen to the Fix-It Show this Saturday starting at 7 a.m. with Accurate Basement Repair's Chris Mancuso.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
A53 Wisconsin's Morning News, WTMJ 5-day forecast sponsored by Dave Drake Camp Heating, where your comfort is their family's tradition. High 41 today, low down to 25. And mostly sunny on Thursday with a high of 45 degrees. Friday, rain chance late, 53, your inland high, a bit cooler near the lake. I'll take you through the weekend. Saturday, chance for showers in the morning, then a high of 55 degrees, a little bit cooler near the lake. And Easter Sunday, slight chance of a shower, mostly cloudy, high of 44. Right now, we got 30 degrees in Milwaukee. Supporters of former President Donald Trump here in Wisconsin have been wondering, when are we going to see our guy again? Answer to that question is Tuesday. Former president set to visit Green Bay on Election Day.
His campaign says he'll be holding a rally at the Hyatt Regency Hotel and will speak at 5 o'clock.
Now, Adam and I could clearly have told you that, but always nice to have Susan Kim's voice.
Thank you, Susan.
On the air with us. Not a lot of information available, really, about the event at this point from the Trump folks, so that will come in the coming days. Curious on this choice of venue. Because if you know Green Bay, the Hyatt Regency, it's a beautiful hotel. It's right, gosh, is it Main Street?
Yeah, it's right next to the KI Convention Center,
right.
Isn't it? I mean, you could literally have it right over there.
So I don't know if they're going to be in, like, technically a KI hall that's connected to the Regency. If you know it as well, it's got one of those big atriums with the skylight. And so there's this huge public space in the middle, and all the rooms, you can see them. They go up in the sky like that. And so it's a nice place. It's big enough in terms of hotel space, but it's not, like, a place where you hold one of these huge sort of Trump-style rallies in an arena or in a stadium. I mean, certainly you feel like there was enough appetite for him to put thousands in the Resch Center if he wanted to be in Green Bay or someplace else. So I don't know why they chose this venue, if they deliberately wanted to keep it smaller. It is a ticketed event, and those tickets are open to the public. I imagine those will be snatched up rather quickly. Don't have a number for you in total seats available, but it will be the former president's first visit to the state since 2022.
I think about when President Biden was not his most recent visit, but the one before that when he was on the city's west side. That was a pretty surprise. Hey, he's coming here in 5 days, and it was in a very small warehousey style building over there. I was there covering it for WTMJ, and yeah, it filled to completely the brim, and that was for President Biden making a visit that, yes, it's the president's in town, but his administration has been here a lot. There has been much to do about the former president has not been in Wisconsin. He certainly has a following here in what is very much a swing state. I would imagine if those tickets don't sell out today, it's going to be very quickly after that.
Yeah, and I don't think there's a charge associated with it. Typically, there is not, mm-hmm. but you have to sign up in advance and get those. And so that event, again, it's going to be at the Hyatt Regency in Green Bay coming up on Tuesday, which is also the date of the presidential primary.
And that's not a coincidence that he's here on that day.
So the president headed to Green Bay next week. Business headlines are just ahead, right in front of WTMJ's Steve Scafidi and the Political Power Hour. We'll hear first from the Milwaukee Business Journal's Sean Ryan.
Fans of brunch and Belgian beers should set your calendars for April 3rd when Cafe Benelux reopens in Milwaukee's 3rd Ward. That follows an extensive interior renovation. Versity Blood Research Institute's planned $79 million expansion could gain a final Wauwatosa approval next week. That's the next step toward the start of construction this year and completion in 2026. Freighter Theta Care Health starts construction on an $84 million Oshkosh Hospital campus. It will be complete next year. This is Sean Ryan with MilwaukeeBusinessJournal.com on News Radio WTMJ.
It's here on consignment.